Hey, this is Rosman with Roleplaying Public Radio. We're playing Delta Green, Cultural Resource Management. Here with two backers and Thad. Thad's RPPR, or RPPR's Thad, so.
I am technically a backer. I give you money.
Do you? Oh, thank you.
That's not enough to be in a game unless I'm a special guest.
Yes, well, there you go. Well, that's what the listeners want. So, yes, Cultural Resource Management, which is a part of a national act for, we found archaeological remains while we're digging up something. We need to figure out what to do with these. And when those artifacts have certain symbols on them, Delta Green gets worried. And to put a short point. So as we begin the scenario, all three of you are in an office park. Let's see here. An office park in Santa Fe, New Mexico, rented under a holding company named Consolidated Synergy. Three of you enter an anonymous office around dusk, 6 p.m. I'll say it's March. And you have all gotten there as quickly as you can because your handler, Agent Holden, is waiting for you. You've all told them when you could all make it, so you arranged this. This is a urgent mission, but it is not the most, well, hopefully, so far nothing bad has happened, and they're hoping to keep that.
We're attempting to preempt the bad.
So we have three players. I'll just add from my left to right on the screen. We first have player Keith, and you're the first to get there after Holden. And who is your character?
I am playing Charlie Duquette, U.S. Marshal Service.
Okay. So you enter in the office. And then next up we have Thad.
RPBR is Thad.
Yes, RPBR is Thad, sorry.
Playing Agent Atherton of the EPA.
Okay. So you go in there. And then finally, the last one to show up, but all within minutes of each other, Tim.
Hello, I'm playing Professor Rosa Honani. She is an archaeologist with the Bureau of Indian Affairs.
All right, so the three of you entered in the office. It is practically just an empty office. There's a few chairs, one desk, some papers, a trash bin. It looks like, judging from the paperwork, a fly-by-night multi-level marketing firm was using this place before you. It's been abandoned for a while. So this
no posters on the walls.
There's like one that's torn. But make money fast. That kind of thing. So, but Agent Holden is inside the conference room, which has no windows, and he's just sitting. He's taken the only table in the office there, and you're all just he's. Awkwardly assembled the chairs, and he's just kind of waiting for you. Not quite the impressive briefing rooms you're all used to, but as needs must. So Holden just says, introduces all of you to each other. Whether or not you've worked with each other in the past, I'll let you guys decide. You probably are all stationed in the Southwest region, so that you might have worked together, or you might not have. Thad, would Agent Atherton be working with a U.S. Marshal or an archaeologist?
Unlikely, I think. Yeah. Most of his, I don't know, EPA, CID agents are largely involved with, criminal code, breaking of whatever federal regulations. So it's possible, but kind of unlikely.
Okay. And Keith, would you have been working with Rosa, you think?
I don't think so.
Okay. Sorry, what was Charlie's job again?
Marshall.
Marshall, okay.
All right, so yeah, you're all new to each other, but you all know Holden. You definitely all know, you met him before and worked with him, in some capacity or the other. You're not sure what he does. You're not even sure if that's his real name. He seems to be full-time Delta Green, whatever it is. Although he mentioned the name Delta Green to all of you at least once, but that's about it. He prefers to just refer to them as the group. He's very, very much full-time, spy. And He's not, you know, you've never seen him. You've seldom seen him smile, and he's definitely not smiling now.
Imagine him like the protagonist of Burn Notice.
Yeah. Yeah, a little more burned out. But yeah, so...
So late season Burn Notice.
So... He says, thank you all for coming. I know this is an awkward time for all of you, that you all have your own lives to get to, but this the group is seeing that this is a important task, and I would agree with them. Even though no one has died yet, if we can head off a disaster before the point where there are bodies, I think that would be beneficial. So, as you know, a cultural resource management team in eastern New Mexico, he points to here sort of about the eastern, you know, the eastern middle of the state, was digging up a site, has been surveying a site that was owned by the state trust land, or the state land trust office. The office rented that land out to a petrochemical company, Innskeep Energy, for what appears to be oil sands exploitation, which is odd. There aren't supposed to be oil sands in eastern New Mexico. This is the first such discovery of that. You know, the oil sands are what they have up in Canada and a few other places around the world. The surveyors found petroglyphs and other artifacts indicating a site of some archaeological importance, so the exploitation of the site was stopped until the survey could be completed. The surveyors sent in images to an expert in Polynesian culture because these sites bore an uncanny resemblance, these artifacts, these petroglyphs, bore an uncanny resemblance to a Polynesian religion or cult, depending on what you believe in. This cult is rather obscure, has not been studied, thanks in part to our efforts. It is code, if you were cleared for keywords CTHULHU or DAGON, that is the associated cult with this. Which is mostly known in the Pacific and certain coastal areas. Certainly no, it has never been detected anywhere inland this far before. We need to assess the situation to find out what is on that site. There's also preliminary analysis of our Delta Green case files, which are in a very poor shape. Indicated there was an operation conducted in there in 1957 called Granite Orion. We previously operated there in 1957, I don't know what happened in Granite Orion. All I know is that that particular site was indicated is of significance to the group. So this is now Operation UMBER FARM. Use that in confidential communications. Report to me. I will give you a few different means to communicate with me, both burner phone, encrypted email, and a dead drop location. I will try to relay all messages, inquiries to the group through me. We need to assess this situation, find out what's going on. I have a location where the physical documents behind Granite Orion are. They are in a green box in Dallas, Texas. They might shed light into the situation. Of course, there is the site, the cultural resource management team. The field archaeologists are currently digging these artifacts up. They're quite excited, apparently, to intercept a communication. The fact that there is an anomalous geological activity in there, that these oil sands, plus these petroglyphs, I have a bad feeling about this. I know that's cliche to say, but we just don't know enough what's going on there. Agent Atherton with EPA You will take the lead for the field. These two field agents, maintain cover. Maintain deniability of the group. This may be a long-term operation. This may not be resolved overnight. In fact, I doubt it will be. So do take care to maintain your own lives, except when use your discretion. This is not my only fire in the that I have going on. In other words, I have other priorities as well, so I will leave it to your discretion. I will check in with Atherton on regular intervals. Do you have any questions?
The green box is out of character. How far is Dallas from here?
Santa Fe to Dallas. You can use. Let's see here. That's a Google Maps question. I'll look it up. I'll Google it. I don't give a shit.
It'll feel like forever.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not. Santa Fe, New Mexico. Directions. Let's see. Dallas, Texas. Let's take a look. It's about a 10-hour drive.
Ooh.
Okay. Or a 2-hour flight.
Oh, okay.
But that costs. That would cost. We can try out some of the equipment rules and requisitioning things.
Nice. So, that was my next question.
What's our budget?
Yes, we will be using the standard expense categories. One thing is the group. They have a small trust fund consolidated synergy account that you all have access to. They will put in, I will say right now, there is, they prepaid rent for 6 months on this facility, on this office park, and that has, and then they, I'll just say $5,000 in the bank right now. Mm-hmm. So, let's see here. So you can either spend your own money or request it through your own agencies, because you all work for an agency. Mm-hmm. And, just lie about why you need it, or you can use Delta Green, in which case that's pretty easy to figure out. So requisitioning requires usually a skill roll of some type, bureaucracy, military science for military gear, or, criminology would be for, law enforcement stuff, probably, or, bureaucracy. And then if you want to ask something from Delta Green, something off the books, it's going to have a negative 20 penalty before anything else, just because the group, they already got you a place to store your shit, this office.
Yeah, they've already put in some startup capital.
Yeah, and they did give you some money, so you could do that. The office, they did not only, they have a private security monitoring the site 24/7. And they have their own security alarms that will alert the group themselves if anyone compromises your office. So there's actually a lot. They put a lot of money in securing this office park, so you can use it as a storage facility if you need.
We can feel as secure as we can, here.
So you could, for example, take all the documents you get in Dallas, Texas, and move them to the Santa Fe office, if you wanted to, or if you find shit that you need to, from the site in New Mexico. I'll say it's near Clovis, New Mexico, near the border. It's a bit west of Clovis. So you can do that. So you do have a bit of spending money, but anything big aside from your own shit is going to be there. So I assume you guys have at least a week before you have to check in with your real lives and worry about that shit. Mm-hmm. Because I was in the mission briefing. So any other questions?
They reported this to the Bureau of Indian Affairs. According to conventional history, this should be a Native American site if they found.
They have. In your job at the Bureau of Indian Affairs, you could look into this legitimately.
Okay.
So, they definitely could. That's part of the, a person on the Delta Green email list is, gave me a lot of information on how these things kind of go. So, yeah, I could give you a little... You could... Rosa could explain some of this stuff. Let's see here. So there's a national act, let's see here, for the guidelines for cultural resource management, the National Historic Preservation Act. They found the artifacts, so they stopped digging. The workers stopped digging, then they call in the archaeologists. The archaeologists perform a quick assessment. Then they determine how much it will take to mitigate the impact to the site. The assessment doesn't usually take more than a couple days. That's where they're at right now. It's already going a little longer because, hey, they found something really weird. And they
Which, of course, means that a bunch of people have been on the site.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah, there's workers on the site. The Innskeep Energy probably wants to get this shit done so they can start digging up all that oil sand.
That actually brings me something else. I have a 40 in ecology. Could I figure out, like, how weird is it for this to be in, for oil sands to be in this area? Like, is that...
Sure. Make a roll. Now, one thing about Delta Green is if you make the roll, you get a lot more information. If you don't make it, you still get the core clue kind of information.
Nope.
I also have, let's see here, Dice Stream, which is a little app on the left-hand side. So I can roll for you, or you can roll it on that, or you can use real dice. We'll use the honor system.
I rolled an 81. I do not make it.
Okay. You've never heard of it before happening in this area. I mean, you can Google oil sands and read the Wikipedia. That's what you get. It's not supposed to be here, so it is significant. You know that.
Like it breaks our expectations of how, you know, the world is supposed to function.
Yeah. Well, how did this go under? Well, one thing, even with your failed skill check, it's not a crit fail. So, how did this go undiscovered for so long? I mean, continental in the United States has been pretty extensively studied and surveyed, and people have been trying to figure out where the natural resources are for quite some time. So, why is this just coming to light now?
Hey.
But yeah. Anything else before Holden leaves?
If we find out that this site is really not good, are we going to be able to call in some explosives or bury this under, 10,000 pounds of concrete?
I think as far as I understand, the idea is not necessarily to hit that button unless we absolutely have to.
The problem is that there are already, Holden tells you, there's already too many people involved in this site that we can't discreetly do something like that. If it is the site itself, then you have to figure out a legitimate way to prevent anyone from using it. In that case, the group may be able to give you access to hazardous materials that you could dump on the site.
Atherton twitches.
Yeah. That would make it. That would help. That you could then uncover, quote unquote. Then the EPA could declare it a waste dump or something like that. If there's something on the site that can be destroyed or must be destroyed through the use of explosives, that could be done as well. But you must be absolutely certain because you will be putting your lives and your careers at risk, especially if you do something discreetly, if you do something illegally. We do not have any cover for you in this case. You must act as citizens or through your own agencies or in secret. And then if you get caught, we will the group will not be able to help you.
Okay. So,
it's good to go.
Okay.
Okay. So Holden leaves. You have the office. It's dusk of day zero. The clock starts now. What do you guys want to do?
Well, just figuring out priority. We need information and we need containment. Right now, unless there's a reason not to, I think that people working the actual site and the people working on the site right now should be me and Professor Honani Duquette. I think you're the best candidate to go and get what we need from Dallas. Right now, I need to make the EPA a known factor in what's going on there so that we can start maybe at least giving some impression that we need to clear the site and investigate something. And the professor, I'm assuming you're already, you have connections with either maybe directly some of the archaeologists who are working on it, but it, with people with that field, that you can start generating a list of things that we might be able to tell just from the artifacts, and B, people who have been working on the site for the BIA, because we need a list, we need as thorough a list as we can get of who has been in contact with this.
Agreed.
Yep. Okay. Sounds good.
All right. So it's about 3 hours, a little over 3 hours to get to the site from Santa Fe. So Atherton, you can drive while Rosa uses her laptop and her wireless connection, or for her phone essentially, to do some research on the site ahead of time.
And as far as the Marshall, I don't know if you want to drive or if you want to fly. It kind of obviously flying is faster and more expensive. Driving takes time, etc. I'll leave that up to your discretion.
I think for now I'll just hop on a plane.
Okay. You book a ticket. There at this late of night, there's nothing.
Although you probably will have to drive back, depending on how many documents you're bringing, because I think that bringing the documents here is probably the best idea.
Yeah, it'll be the safest way to go.
Yeah, you don't want luggage handlers touching that stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
I'm sorry. The X-ray scans of these documents reveal nothing but screaming faces. Is that normal?
Is it a bomb? Then no.
All right, so you're going to fly out. Let's see here. Give me, do you want high or low? There is the new luck rules, by the way, is just a 50-50 chance. So do you want good low or good high?
Let's go high.
All right, 51 and above. Get a 96. You succeed. There is a flight leaving, in an hour, so you can get there tonight.
Nice.
You take off to the airport, booking your ticket as you on the phone. So you'll be there fairly very soon. Okay. And so meanwhile, you two are driving to outside of Clovis, because that's a good name for a small town in the Delta Vincent area. So, Rosa, go ahead and give me some kind of skill check. What do you want to use to research a site?
I have a number of skills I could use. Archaeology, history, occult.
Well, you don't have anything to look at right yet, actually. Looking at your sheet, actually use bureaucracy, and you can find out. You can, like, basically look through your emails and intranet or office network and see what people have been saying about it at work.
All right. 21 out of 60.
21 out of 60. All right. Which is a success. So, let's see here. There is the. Let's see. All right. So you find out the person who is leading the field archaeologists to study this site, the CRM team, is a Dr. Paisley Forsyth from New Mexico State University, which I don't know if that is one or not. Just a local state state university. Now. Yeah, there is now. And people. You find out that she's already requested assistance from the Bureau to help, stop all commercial exploitation of the site, at least for the time being until a full excavation can be done. Like, can you guys help me dig this stuff? Because I'm finding crazy stuff. This is a new find. And people are, getting suspicious. She has Dr. Forsyth. Has good credibility with a whore, but she sounds like she's hinting at something big, and she is people are why are she doesn't even have to apparently she's sleeping at the site she's not that close to the town.
No.
She's really excited about it I like how that's oh god, it's too late. She's sleeping at the site.
Well, somebody get a shallow grave ready. What? No.
Nope, we gotta put her down.
Well, I'm gonna be optimistic at first. Can I put in a request for a background check on her?
You have her file, like she's been
to
the Bureau before. But you do find out another lead from that, which is she has been talking to someone at the Library of Congress. Who, let's see here, random name generator. Sorry, I don't have all the NPCs here yet. Monster. A doctor, Chad Morrison.
Chad, okay.
Who is an expert, you can easily Google his name. He is an expert in Southeast Asia and Polynesia and, like, Oceania. Especially Oceania, like,
The setting of 1984?
Well, oceanic, like, cultures, like, you know.
I know.
Alright, so. So that's unusual why he's an expert in all kinds of old civilizations, so, you know. But it is a bit weird that is his forte. So, you figure all. I mean that. So meanwhile, so you figure that out before you lose connection. That's about as all you can do. You can talk to Atherton if you want to try and introduce yourselves, because it is you still have some time.
All right. Well, how long you been with the group?
Really, just this past year, I got roped in by let's say a colleague of mine. And so it's been a time. How about yourself?
From what I remember, it's been about 2 years. I kind of lost some time.
Oh.
I just want to get it out of the way in case you get my file and read it. I've been cleared by the psychs. I'm fine. And I'm probably better for not having remembered.
Yeah. I mean, I really only. This is.
It was a burial mound. Okay. Apparently, something happened in there. I don't even know.
Is there like a general like part of the state I should be staying away from, or?
If I could tell you, I would tell you.
Right.
Okay.
Well, that's. That'll be a good thing to add to the stuff that keeps me awake. Okay, well, I mean, thanks for telling me. I don't have any particular, psychological damage thus far. I'm really not on particularly great terms with the partner of mine who brought me in, but, we got to do what we got to do. So I'm here, and we gotta cordon this shit off. I don't know. I work a lot. I like to garden, which is a great thing in this part of the country.
All right. So that's how their conversation goes.
Atherton's like, oh, of course, something else.
Yeah. So Duquette, your flight gets to Dallas on time. You're at the airport. What kind of car do you want to rent?
Some kind of blacked out SUV.
Blacked out, not really so much at the airport, but they do have SUVs, so you can get something roomy. So there goes another couple hundred bucks. How long are you renting it for?
Just the day. I'm just going to get the files and go
just
back.
Hauling documents, just get a U-Haul.
Okay. Well, there's not a U-Haul at the airport. That they would not have that. And it's also 8 o'clock at night. By the time you get there, so.
Okay, spend the night in the green box. It'll be fun.
Yeah, I could do that.
One question on the flight over, as I'm blasting Cannibal Corpse, can I roll on unnatural to see if Cthulhu or Dagon rings a bell?
Sure. Tell me exactly what you roll to.
Alrighty.
I did that too.
89.
Failed hard.
89.
Yeah.
What is your? You think back at your own background. What do you think? Actually, do you want to know?
God, that's the question.
Things man does not want to think about.
Yeah, let's see if I have a little rage episode renting the car.
Oh, God, am I the only sane man?
I picked a fun disorder.
All right, so you do want to know?
Yeah.
All right, you lose one sanity. And you do know. You don't know how you know. It's not your area of expertise. It wasn't anything you encountered. But you know there are things that walk that ought to crawl. But in there is an intelligence in the oceans. You start to sweat on the plane, even though it's quite cool.
You wish you could get farther from the ocean all of a sudden.
You're far from the ocean, but you also you think of the land that you're above right now on the plane, and you realize it wasn't always dry. Years ago, it was an ocean.
200 million years ago.
Yeah.
I raise my hand for a whiskey from the stewardess.
And there may be something was there, something that... Oh God! You don't want to think about it anymore.
The land is dry doesn't mean it doesn't remember how it was once wet.
Yes. So, yeah, that name you've never heard it before, have you? But yet it's familiar to you. It's not. Ooh, yeah. Make a sand check.
Oh boy. And I failed that one.
Oh my God.
You are a raging asshole. So
fucking car.
You're driving out of the airport when someone cuts you off, and it's just been boiling up. And you're a marshal. You can carry a gun legally.
Oh, yeah. Oh God.
Yeah.
I have a big gun too.
You do have a big gun. So luck, high or low?
Oh God, I'll go low on this one.
All right. 77. So you get out of your car before you realize it, and you are yelling you rear end the guy, and you know your nice new rented SUV, and you're out there screaming at the guy before you realize that you've caused quite a scene. And you don't pull your gun out, but you show him the holster. And the other guy is terrified, and he backs away immediately. Give me one more sand check. As you look back, you see there are other people in the car. There was a family.
Well, I passed that one. I got 15.
All right. It's fine. Whew. You know, you don't have to escalate it anymore. They ran away, and you were leaving the airport. But yeah, you almost shot a guy for that before you came to.
Great start. Great start.
Good. Hopefully you paid for the extra insurance.
Yeah.
So yeah, and the car's already dented. So the front bumper is already dented when you rear-ended the guy. It looks cosmetic, but it's definitely a big scratch. So yeah. By the way, I guess you must have used your name for this, because you don't have any fake ID on you.
Yeah. Damn it.
So, all right. Just keeping that in mind. So you head on over to the green box. Holden gave you guys a key, then he told you which storage facility it's at. It's just a self-storage system with 24-hour access. So we'll get to you back to you in the next. All right, Atherton and Rosa. You guys are nearing the site. It's outside of Clovis. It's night. It's obviously it's a bit of a drive from the road itself, so you'd have to go to take a back road. You can't just see it from the highway.
The good thing is it sounds like there'll be someone there 24 hours.
Try to do that right now. Well, I mean, what do you want to do? Like, it's night right now. You could get a hotel. You could try and find. I mean, the other people. Probably not everyone's out there. People from Innskeep Energy that you could try to find. You could just get some sleep for a big bright early morning.
I think find a hotel, and I'm gonna see about like basically sending off some emails or something, contact people from Innskeep Energy to set up some meetings tomorrow to, because I'm the EPA agent who's looking into this find, and I need to be brought up to speed.
Okay, that would definitely be, I would say, deception or bureaucracy.
We'll go with bureaucracy. Oh, damn it. 71 out of 60.
Okay. You get a curt email reply back. That refers you to their lawyer. They don't want a energy company. They don't exactly want to fucking talk to the EPA. And you realize you sort of, there's no EPA necessary right now.
Oh, really? You know what? No, that's not flying. they're investigating a find that, by all general ecological understanding, shouldn't be there, and they're gonna shut me down? No. That's not how this is happening. Let's see. It's a lower score, but I'm gonna fucking go for it. I want to roll law and see if there's that I can figure out like a way to elbow myself in.
Well, you can research that. You have to burn the midnight oil for that, so you lose a point of power. Okay.
I lose in the meantime, I'll do the same thing, but under the auspices of the BIA.
Okay, you can. You don't have to roll. You can just email Dr. Forsythe and say you'll be there to assess that. In fact, you'll get brownie points with the Bureau because you can just say, hey, no, I'm already in town. I could do this. It's a work vacation, so...
I'll be there an hour later than Thad wanted to show up.
Okay, so you're doing that for tomorrow morning?
I'm also going to the... Is there a gas station nearby?
Yeah, there's a gas station in town. Not next to the site. Like I said, the site's a ways off.
Yeah. I want an emergency desert-like survival care package.
Okay.
Just set up, just in case we have to run screaming into the desert.
Okay. Give me a survival check. No, Sir Kirk, go ahead, survival.
All right, 40 out of 50.
All right, you pick the stuff that could be used, and it's, not top-of-the-line stuff because, you're getting it from a gas station.
Right.
But it's you can use your Consolidated Synergy card. And so is this kit, are you going to hide this somewhere or are you going to take it with you?
No, this is, sensible to take when you're in the desert. So
it's going to be a
backpack kit.
Okay, so you pack out, and enough for two people, you and your federal agent. You even find a flare gun, I'll say. You made your skill check, so...
Nice.
So you can have a weapon if it comes to that.
So, I do have a weapon.
Yeah. Well, you can never have enough to weapon. Flare
true.
Guns are always useful, unless you try to kill yourself with one, which is... that was a fun game. Atherton, go ahead and give me a law check.
Yeah, this is going to be funny, since law is at 30. Damn it, 35.
I'll give you a bonus for that, because, no, that is a good point. It's ecologically, you can basically, there's legal precedence for saying, if they're doing something that's obviously bullshit, you can investigate them, and there's no record of oil sands being here, so what are they really doing if you just assume deception?
Right.
So you realize you could do that to force a meeting with them tomorrow.
Excellent.
They're definitely going to be hostile. They're not going to like you. But
good.
All right. Fair enough. So you spend the... do you guys get different hotel rooms or the same one?
Different. I would say.
All right, so Rosa, you get
terrorists.
You send out some emails, get some meetings arranged, and you go to sleep. You are Atherton is up until 3 in the morning, and you get the email back at 5 in the morning, and they're like, well, all right, fine, fuck. So they will meet with you as well, but you didn't get much sleep, so.
Yeah, how much willpower did I lose for not sleeping?
Just one.
Okay, cool.
I assumed everyone was, bright-eyed and, fully rested when we started the scenario.
Well, that's going downhill.
I'll give you that mercy. In the meanwhile, back to Duquette, you drive over to, the storage facility and let yourself in. It's an air-conditioned, you know, environmentally controlled storage locker. You know, you slide the door up. There's an odd chemical smell in the room in the storage thing. There's just boxes and boxes of cardboard boxes filled with documents. There is a wooden crate in one corner, and you can see a plastic tarp has been laid down on the floor. There's some wooden pallets. There's a locked metal shelf in the other corner. So what do you you can use research or bureaucracy to try and like dig through the files. You could try and open the wooden crate. Or the metal cabinet is locked, so you're gonna, and you don't have a key for that. It looks like it's quite old. It's, you know, and heavily battered too.
All right. I guess I'll roll bureaucracy to go through the boxes.
Okay.
And that's a 38 out of 60.
38 out of 60. All right. So. It takes you a few hours, but you do find, because you're looking for Operation, there's a lot of code names, and there's a lot of interview files. It's just, you know, you're used to bad record keeping, from, you know, like local, dealing with local law enforcement and shit like that. Just no city cop can keep records, right, and you're used to bad, but this is an entirely another, it's like, you know, they have like, oh, here's a police interview file. Here's something entirely different. Here's a ripped page from a book, and it's all stapled together with some, you know, code name on it, and that's supposed to be it. That was an operation apparently. But so you're looking for Operation Granite Orion, and you're looking through all of these case files, and a lot of them, it seems like, are actually nothing. Apparently, Delta Green spent decades mostly chasing. Phantoms, at least, like, oh, we heard weird thing happen, we checked it out, it was nothing. There's a lot of those. It's at least a good third of them. Then you find Operation Granite Orion. And there's a newspaper clipping. In 1957, grisly murder of hikers near Clovis, New Mexico.
I'm going to stop reading there and wait till I get back with the team to finish that one.
Well, as you're looking at it, there is a photo, and it shows there is a to-do file written in pencil on it. Like, let's see here. Dr. Kinson, autopsy, what's in this? And there's a photo of the metal cabinet. Of the metal shelf. It's on like a dirt, it's on the desert, you know, it's like somebody, it looks like somebody took something and put it in the metal cabinet and then just put it in the storage facility. But it looks like Dr. Kinson never autopsied what was in there.
Wait, you mean there's a metal like container in the green box that is...
Yes.
Oh.
That's the locker room.
Okay.
And that's the photo from 1957. There's like some people, some men's feet, you know, there's some boots and pants in the thing, but it's a photo of the cabinets on its side, and it's locked up, and looks like it was, they put chains around it too, but, you know, they didn't, so, yeah, there's no chains around it now, it's just locked with like a padlock.
Do I jump on this grenade, guys?
I'm not there. Look, I can't give you particular.
All right, you know what?
Well, you can call us.
Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna step out, light up a cigarette, and call these guys.
Okay. You call him? Who are you calling first?
I'll call Atherton.
Yeah, Atherton's still up.
Yeah. Hello.
Hey, it's Duke.
Yeah. Hey. Oh, is that what you? Okay. I didn't know to call you that.
Yeah, it's easier. Okay. Anyways, I'm here at the.
Wait, is it spelled D-U-Q?
Yeah.
Huh. Sorry, anyways. I was a little slap happy.
So I'm here at the green box. I found the files. There's a picture of a little metal shelf here, and this shelf is in the box and it's locked up. Do I need to peek inside this?
It's referenced in the case file.
Well, how sturdy does it look?
It's very sturdy. I mean, it's thick metal.
Could it fit in the SUV?
Yeah. It would be a bitch to carry it, to lug there, but, you know, you could do it.
It would probably be best to bring it to the offices. I mean, I'm sure that the green box is secure, but there's probably plenty of other sensitive information and items in there that if opening that draws any kind of attention, we don't want it drawn to the box.
All right, gotcha.
If you can just like, if you could carefully dolly that into your whatever you're hauling stuff in, that would probably be better.
All right, sounds good.
Okay.
All right. Last things last, that wooden crate.
Well, you'd have to re-Granite Orion if they reference a wooden crate. You don't know.
No, I'm not even not in a reference for this. I'm looking for extra firepower.
Okay. All right, so you open it up. Go ahead and give me a sand check.
Yeah, fuck. I passed.
Okay. Well, there is a mummified human hand in it. Severed.
I'm just gonna close that back up.
Well, there's other things in there too. I wasn't done. Jeez. Okay. But that was for the hand, cause like, oh shit. There is some pottery. It looks...
Wait, hold on. When you say mummified human hand, do you mean, like, does it look intentionally mummified, or does it look like, well, this hand was somewhere for a really long time?
Yeah, it's just professional or...
It's not wrapped in bandages. It just looks really, desiccated and dried out. Like, naturally mummified. It wasn't...
Okay.
If it was ritually mummified, they ripped the bandages off, or, the wrappings off.
Gotta rip the bandage off.
Yep. So there's some Native American pottery in there. There is a tomahawk. An old tomahawk. Still looks quite sturdy, though. And there's some dark stains along its the head of it. And then there is a small metal box inside the metal crate. It looks like an ammo box.
I'm sure it's not ammo, but I'll open it.
Okay. You open it up. There are three wrapped. There are three things wrapped in cloth in it.
Oof. All right, I'll unwrap one.
Okay. It's a revolver. Looks like a 44 stumnose revolver.
Hey, nice, just like mine. I'm gonna stuff that in the back of my jeans. I'll see what's in cloth number two.
You see a, let's see here, it's a .38 revolver, and yeah. Oh. You actually can see that the serial number has been melted off with acid. It leaves a very obvious scar on it, but there's no, everything about it has been removed. Any identifying marks on it have been removed.
All right, awesome. And number three.
Okay. There is a, you're not sure exactly what it is. It's organic, whatever it is.
Oh God.
Yeah. It's something that looks like it was cut off, and it's just, give me one more sand check.
Oh boy. Pass. Got a 9.
All right. You're not a biologist. You're just like, but you kind of like, ew, gross. And you put it back in there. looks like they cut it off of something.
Oh, God. All right, well, that whole crate and the metal shelf are going to go in the SUV along with the documents.
The metal shelf, the crate is going to?
Yeah.
Okay.
Wait, the crate that isn't related to our stuff you're taking?
Well, with the Native American pottery, this isn't a Native American site. Or, I mean, if it's not related, then no, I'm not going to take it. But.
Yeah, it's not related.
All right.
You are taking the two handguns?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Okay. So you get the handguns. There are some bullets there too. Sorry. I'll say each gun is fully loaded. But that's it. You'd have to buy more ammo to get it.
Make a pit stop on the way home. Well, not home.
Yeah, because they won't have security cameras or anything. So I know.
Damn it.
Yep. You take the two handguns. All right. So go ahead and give me a string times one check to move the metal shelf.
Oh, that's not going to be good. No.
Okay. You actually do move it, but it slips at one point because your hands get sweaty because, you know, that's a heavy object. And you cut your hand along the edge of it, and a bit of blood drips inside the shelf.
Oh, God damn it.
Get a dolly.
This is why you wear gloves and get a dolly.
There was no dolly, and there are no gloves.
Anyway.
Yeah.
Anyways, so yeah.
It doesn't even take a point of damage, though. You just... Yeah.
It's just a little cut. Who
it's
would
just
even...
plot blood?
Yeah, no problem. No problems at all.
Yep. All right. So you get the documents, you get the two handguns, and you get the metal shelf, and that's it, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So you pack all that up, and you start driving. I assume you're just going to be driving the 10 hours straight, just stopping for gas and food. When you absolutely necessary. Okay. That'll take 1d4 willpower, because it fucking sucks.
All right. I lost my caltrop, if you want to roll for me.
Okay. Four willpower.
Nice.
Because as you're driving back, every time you hit something in the road, you think something in the shelf slides or moves. There's something in it. There's definitely something in it. But sometimes the road is smooth, and you hear something something sliding against metal. It's very faint. But that can't be. No, you're just imagining things.
The 44 I picked up is on the center console.
Okay.
Like within hand's reach.
That's fair. So it doesn't. You don't have to make a sand check, but it is a bit taxing. You wonder if you should turn the radio on and blast whatever, or if it's better to have that, you know, hear everything perfectly. So you go back and forth, and there's nothing on the radio except crazy preachers and talk radio late at night and music from the hearts of space. You're not sure which is worse.
If only there was vaporwave here to save us.
Unfortunately, there is not, because it's not on the radio, those Philistines. That's how you're, let's hear. Actually, it doesn't take you, are you going to the Santa Fe office then? Okay, so that's a full 10 hours. So that's fun for you. Mm-hmm. So let's hear, so 10, you got there about 10, so you'll get to Santa Fe about 8 a.m., I guess. Which is just in time for the first meeting for, I guess, Atherton. Meeting with a, let's see here, random name generators. Why can't I come up with better ones?
I guess I didn't put this on my character sheet, but is it all right if I have a, like, a recording device?
Sure. Yeah. That's not too hard. You could actually use your cell phone.
That makes sense.
We'll just say Brian, let's see here, Peters is one of the managers. He's actually the corporate overseer of the CRM dig team and the site right now, because they have company reps on site or, like, watching the archaeologists do their work, making sure that they're, you know, doing their job right. And that kind of thing. So Brian Peters will meet with you.
Hmm.
So you meet at a, let's say, conference room at the hotel. You can book that pretty easily. So you have your little coffee. You look a little worn. You know, you've had better nights. But Brian Peters is like, hello, Mr. Atherton, is it?
With yes. You? Morning. Hold on. Gulp down the rest of the coffee that I was drinking.
Okay. I wasn't aware that there was any environmental concern with this. We have a we are talking with the appropriate agencies about the cultural impact of our this site. But yeah. Well,
I gotta tell you, Mr. Peters, and I apologize if my messages sent last night were brusque. I'm sort of late to this party myself, but I gotta say, a find of this nature where it is not likely just geologically to have been found. Plus the fact that the kind of mining that you're going to need to do to take, you know, to get oil sands is going to involve, you know, a pretty specifically messy scale of strip mining and various other things. I gotta say, I find the incredulity toward oversight or even just an extra look by the appropriate agencies to be a little surprising. Like, you really didn't expect anyone to want to maybe take a second look at something. And I understand, all right? I am a creature of bureaucracy myself. I understand that your business is probably already on your ass about the BIA stuff, but come on. This is not where this kind of fine happens. You know we got to have a look. Like, this stuff has to be cleared. Atherton is clearly on caffeine.
Yeah. What kind of skill do you want to roll for that? Persuade, bureaucracy, law.
I was gonna, I guess, give bureaucracy another try.
Okay, sure.
Because it is higher than my persuade. Mm-hmm. God, period, damn it. 68 out of 60.
Look, we will follow all EPA regulations as required. Once we get to that, we barely broke ground when we found the first artifacts, which they're quite shallow. I mean, it seems like a hoax, if you ask me. This Dr. Forsythe is claiming there's a connection between, you know, the Navajo and other tribes with tribes from Polynesia and, you know, thousands of miles away. Like some hippie planted something 10 feet down.
Yeah, no, look, I don't like the humanities either, but the thing is, you're already breaking ground on a site that is just scientifically strange, and you're giving me the runaround on this. Like, this is not you. Okay, let me back up for a second, because you're breaking ground on this already. Can I ask, what is the provenance of this find? Like, if this has been here for literally ever, or at least however long.
That's definitely persuade.
Okay. Two, motherfucker.
All right. Okay. Look. I understand that you might think we're not fracking, if that's your concern. We're not trying to hide up another fracking site or anything like that. We're not trying to. I know fracking's not very popular, especially if we're close to a town and everything. This really is oil sands, which we have a plan for a more environmentally conscious way than what they're doing up in Alberta. Mm. I understand that. I have my own people trying to answer this question too, and it seems that there was a conspiracy, if you want to call it that, between some local townspeople, the sheriff, and some people in the state trust land office who kept certain geological survey results hidden or misfiled them.
So the survey results have been there, but they've been, like, somebody made them go away.
Yes, those people are all dead or in retirement home, as far as I know. So I don't know why they did that. I guess they didn't want any. I mean, oil sands weren't really valuable back in the 50s.
Yeah,
you know, 56 or 8 or whatever. Mm-hmm. And so I don't know why they didn't. I guess they didn't want anyone to. I don't know why they did it, but they did it.
All right. Well, look. I appreciate the pressure that you're probably already under, and I know me butting my nose in isn't helping. But I mean, this area, and I don't know where you hail from, but I mean, I come from, you know, New England, East Coast stuff. So the fracking is essentially the F word out there.
And we're not fracking.
I know.
Oils are a lot better than oil fracking. We're not pumping anything in the water.
You know that, and I know that, but. Yeah. You know how it is. I got to lift up the chain. I got to make sure for the people who, you know, sign the bills in the legal sense, as well as, you know, sure. Nobody wants to be associated with the big F word, as it were.
The oil sands will create a lot of jobs. It's better for the environment.
Look, I'm not a. Look,
I'm just saying, you know, if you can help us out with these EPA, the other people at your agency, I'm really surprised that you guys are here already. I mean, you're seldom reactive.
It's sent up flags partly because you know how it is. The people, lawmakers in the area.
Let's help each other. You help me, and I'll help you. I mean. Mm-hmm. Let's just be, we're not the enemy here. We want to comply. Let's just, you know, I want to dig up those oil sands, but I think we can do it in a good way for America and for the economy and for the environment.
Look, if things are as you say they are, and that's all I'm here to find out, make sure everything is, make sure the fines are, you know, that was a bit of information I did not have that'll be really useful. Hopefully it'll smooth things out.
Yeah, you can talk to my, okay, if you want, give me another persuade or bureaucracy check.
Okay. Bureaucracy keeps failing me, but let's try again. 16, all right.
Okay. Look, I have an assistant who's doing this, Spencer Lee. Here's his information. He's the one who brought this to, he's been looking into this, trying to figure out why this land was kind of a no-go.
Just making sure there's nothing.
So you can talk to him, he'll explain why, you know, what happened, why this land wasn't properly categorized, why this discovery was kept secret.
Right.
You know, so talk to Spencer. I'll tell him to talk to you. You know, just I don't want to have any problems from the EPA once we get this dig mitigated. Once we dig up these artifacts, we haven't found any remains. It's so far, so I don't think we're gonna. It's not a burial ground. It's just, you know, there's some pottery shards and some glyphs. And I think we can get this done in a week, okay?
All right. Well, I will do my best to get my end of things done quickly. Okay. I'll be in touch. Here's my card. All
right. So you exchanged information. You had a pleasant meeting. Good job. Rosa.
Yep.
How are you doing? Okay. You want to talk to Dr. Forsythe, correct?
I believe so.
Yes. All right. So she emails you that you can come up to the dig site and talk to her. There's so much to do.
Okay. All right.
She's very excited. She uses exclamation points.
Okay.
very portentous exclamation points, apparently. So you get directions to the site itself. It's about 30 minutes outside of Clovis. Several back roads. You have to take it kind of slow. You don't have to make a driving check or anything. It's
only, okay.
Unless you're trying, unless you're trying to make a new world record or anything.
Nope. No hurry at this point.
All right. So you get there. You see construction equipment. Bulldozers and backhoes, and there's a trailer there. It looks like Innskeep Energy was beginning to, dig up the site. But now there, you see the little familiar little grid lines, string grid lines, of a archaeological dig, and there's about you count about 8 people out there, all digging. Let's see here. They're using what they call a total station. They've already got a total station there, which is unusual. It is a sometimes called a transit. It looks like a big yellow camera on a tripod. They are basically using it. It has a GPS. It's a digital camera with a GPS. So they dig something up. They take a photo of it with the GPS coordinates, so they can then removed and then taken away for study. So they're digging. They're already set up for sort of a long-term dig, even though they're still in the they're just supposed to be studying for the mitigation. To figure out how big this site is, but they're already really pushing ahead of the schedule. You can tell that automatically. Without any
evidence. How many days has it been since they first unearthed something?
Apparently about a little under a week since the construction workers broke ground, found something called people.
That's pretty fast.
It is very fast. So you get out of your car, you see Dr. Forsythe, you recognize her from her, faculty photo. and on the New Mexico State University website. She waves at you and says, "Dr. Hona, I presume. Was it Hona? Honani? Honani. I presume. She kind of laughs at her own joke.
Just call me Rosa.
Okay, Rosa. I am, well, then you can, let's see, you call me Paisley. Well, welcome. I'm glad that the Bureau sent someone out already. This is a major, major find. I'm really excited. This is going to be really,
I can see that.
Yeah. Yeah, I pulled a few strings, called a few grad students in, I know it's a little ahead of schedule, but I'm just so excited about this dig. I mean, it's, wow.
Let me get some very vital things right out of the way. Have you found any remains?
No human remains yet, no.
Okay.
There have been some animal bones found, although I think those are kind of incidental. It's a really complex site. And so she starts talking to you. Give me archaeology check.
Archaeology.
She explains this in great detail.
Digging up dead things.
Come on, roll. Okay, there we go. 20. 20 out of 60, or 70, I think.
All right. She's telling you she has found some. It's a complex site because it looks like there's a lot of artifacts from different times and different cultures. And there's some erratics, there's some more recent stuff. It looks like people were using the site up until the 50s, 1950s. And so it's been continuously occupied for hundreds of years, but by small numbers of people, it looks like, but from different areas. But she's using the technical terms and all this other stuff. So, okay. She explains it, just started guiding you through it, and it's a very unusual site because, we're just beginning to get more information out of it. We don't know much else. It's just we're finding things from, different kind of weapons and tools associated with different tribes from a wide area. And then we found those petroglyphs, and the petroglyphs are, associated with this Polynesian. They're practically identical. She takes you to a table, point, and shows you a petroglyph. It shows a humanoid with sort of tentacles coming out of his face.
Okay.
And she shows you a photo from a tablet that shows an almost identical figure from a, let's say, a oceanic tribe from, over 1,000 years ago.
Okay.
They're literally identical.
First of all, metagame-wise, my character is native. Has she heard anything about this region?
You can give me a Hopi check. Yeah, you can use your language check to see if you've heard that story. Hopi. All
right. Come on. 52. I don't think that makes it. Let me check.
Your Hopi is listed at 70.
Oh, 70? Okay, that makes it.
It says, yeah, so.
70, yep.
You get a sinking feeling in your stomach. You've heard of a place. You didn't know it was this place, but there's a place that is, they just call it the land for the exiles. A literal bad land. You remember there was a place where, renegades or people who were cast out from their tribes, not just, from all over, where would they go? They were exiled from their own homelands, and other tribes wouldn't accept them because they were usually, bad people, murderers and thieves and whatnot. But there was one area that they were kind of drawn to, and maybe this is that area. There's something spiritually wrong with the land, like it was cursed, or there was something. You remember hearing stuff about like they would dream wrongly. They had wrong dreams, or the dreams of you don't remember the details. You'd have to go and go back and call, you know, talk to some people to remember the exact details.
God damn it, Uncle, stop being right.
Yeah. But it's definitely like a land of exiles. Like, this is the cursed land. This is, so, and everyone else would stay away from it, because if you spent the night on the land, you'd know it was wrong.
Okay. Okay, back to conventional scholarship.
So you kind of fade out a bit, you know, thinking back, and then she's still talking. So go ahead and give me a bureaucracy check to see if you can figure out what the hell she's been talking about the last couple of minutes.
18 out of 60.
Okay. She's talking about getting funding now. She's talking about stopping the site forever, stopping the Innskeep Energy forever, because, you know, this is too important. Or at least for 6 months to a year. Like, it's that big, you know. She's
shit. Yeah. As an aside, I do have unnatural and I have occult at 80.
Okay.
Do I recognize the petroglyphs?
Go ahead and give me a roll for both.
97 on occult, so I missed that.
Okay.
07 on unnatural.
Ooh, give me a sand check.
This is totally getting projected on my uncle.
Roll that beautiful sand footage.
All right. 28, made it.
Okay. You remember part of your last job now.
Oh, no.
You were in Massachusetts. You were near a place called Innsmouth that was no longer a town. They were saying that there was this guy here. There were two military people with you. They were like, we need to find... It kind of blurs out, but they're saying, like, it came back from the ocean looking for it. We have to get it before it does. You know? And they start mentioning the House of Dagon, the House of Cthulhu. We can't wake up too early. The stars aren't right yet, all right? And you just get this dread feeling. There's another project. The operation was Azure Shoe.
They can't all be good.
Yeah, that's a bad project name. Azure Shield. Shield. So that's a project name you could look up that would have a hell of a lot more information on Cthulhu. So your last job involved it. It's definitely a bad thing. But it's from the ocean. Why the fuck is it here?
I'm gonna try to keep that off my face.
Well, she doesn't notice at all. You actually can give me a human. Well, you have a human at base. That's great. Go and give me a wonderful.
24.
All right. Yeah. So no, you're fine. You're fine. Yeah. Everything's fine.
Yeah.
So, Doctor or Paisley does not seem to notice anyway. She's enraptured with this stuff. So, do you have any questions for her?
Well, let's see. I asked if there were human remains because I was hoping that they would find some so we could at least temporarily close it off.
Nope, no remains yet.
Okay. I asked, you know, who she has on site, who she's contacted. You know, I just want to see who she's already touched with the madness.
I'm sorry, what was that again?
I just want to see who she's already called in on this. Like, okay. I know she's got some grad students.
Grad students are lost causes already. Like, they'll welcome death.
It's a mercy, yes.
Yeah. All the grad students she's contacted are already here. Like, everyone, I mean, it sounds like a career-making opportunity if this pans out the way she's spinning it, you know.
And cultist, yes.
Whoa, that's harsh. So
okay,
she's contacted people at the Bureau of Indian Affairs, and she's also contacted people in her own university and some other archaeologists, but nobody else has really bitten at it. All the people who believe in her are already here. There's one other full archaeologist. Let's see here. There's six grad students, her, and let's see here. Doctor, let's see.
Dr. Steve.
No. Gregory Webster.
Gregory Webster, okay. And then what about on-site security? A site with this sort of potential could draw looters.
Well, we haven't. That's a good point. That's why I've been sleeping here, along with yes. Dr. Webster's in town.
That's bad.
But three of the grad students are. So we've been here. Innskeep Energy. I've been trying to get Innskeep Energy to provide security guards, but they haven't so far. So.
And they're the ones funding all of this right now, right?
Yeah, they have to do it because of the National Act.
All right.
So at this point, everyone's caught up. Everyone's synchronized, so you can have a group conference call. As Duke is hauling shit in to the office. There's a realtor office across the way in the office park.
Is there a dolly or anything on site that we can use?
There is at the office. So you managed to wheel in the metal cabinet without incident.
Did you rent it dinged up like that? Because I would have asked for a discount.
Oh, you know, yeah, I got it cheaper like that.
Nothing to worry about. It's 8:00 in the morning. So are you driving back to Santa Fe after this?
Right.
You're in Clovis. You're about 3 hours away. So you could drive back.
I guess conference call then, because yeah, I'm gonna stay out here for a bit.
Okay. So conference call. What do you guys want to do?
When you guys are on your way back, can you grab sounds strange, a length of chain and some padlocks?
Do they not already have those in Santa Fe?
I didn't want to get out of the car. Listen, you'll see. Just get some
Okay.
I'm back. Just get some heavy duty towing chain.
Okay. Anything in the documents?
Oh yeah. I haven't looked at them yet though.
Oh okay. Well, I mean, I got some hits just from talking with. I'm gonna talk to his assistant later today, or tomorrow. What time is it?
It's about 8 a.m. now.
Nine a.m.
So yeah. Well, by the time Duke got back to the office, you guys had Rosa and Atherton finished their first meetings.
Okay.
I'm probably walking back to my car as we're talking on the phone.
I'm gonna set up a meeting with the assistant of a guy at the Innskeep company because apparently, as far as they've been able to tell, the reason why this find wasn't on record is because it was specifically hidden. Can you guess when those documents were shoved underground? I'll give you a hint. It's between 1956 and 1958.
Oh boy.
Yeah. So I'm gonna talk to the assistant. He's apparently been looking into this. The guy I talked to at Innskeep said a lot of the people involved were dead, but he did say some were retired. So there may be some people who were involved with Granite Orion actually kicking around.
Well, if we can dig up, if there's any maybe cold cases identified with any missing people, any fugitives, I can maybe pull some strings and get jurisdiction over the area and shut it down.
Yeah, well, you said over the phone before that there was dead hikers or something. That was part of what was going on.
No, that wasn't you.
He did see the first thing in the Granite Orion. A newspaper clipping of two hikers who apparently murdered each other or something.
It wasn't just murder. It was murder, suicide.
Well, he did. He specifically said he wasn't gonna read it. So.
Oh, okay.
Two hikers found murdered is that.
Okay. Well, I mean, if you got law enforcement credentials, I would say start looking into the murder. If there's any other criminal history there, doctor, what do you got?
I can definitely confirm that this place crawls.
Oh, good.
This is not good. I think I need to talk to some local tribal elders. I have some half-remembered kid stories that unfortunately line up with, you know, people going missing in this area and getting killed in this area. So the
people who are from here have known there's something wrong with this place for as long as there's been.
The natives might.
Awesome. Sorry, that's what I mean. The people who are really from here, not just, you know.
Yeah. I want to make sure. I'm going to double check. But, yeah, this place definitely needs to go. Oh, by the way, there are people here all the time.
Okay. So that's good.
That's...
All right. Well, hopefully we're not dealing with anything that's... you know what? I'm not going to think about that right now.
If you can get Atherton to... or not Atherton. The energy company to stop their funding, that would help out a lot. Because right now, they're only working on them.
I mean, that's going to be a hard sell. They're really happy with this fine, from what I could tell by the I don't know, financial stiffy that Mr. Peters was walking around with.
Well, Peters basically, well, no, you know, as the EPA agent, basically he wants the fine to, like, be done with. He does want it. It's an impediment to building.
So the longer they can be established, the longer the dig can be established, the less they're going to want to hold on to the claim, because the cost will outweigh the benefit. So of course, the trouble is, the longer that's there, we're going to be putting the archaeologists at work in threat if we're feeding into that.
Yeah. No, Innskeep definitely wants the archaeologists to hurry the fuck up. Sorry if I gave that, but like he's really excited because it's a new source of revenue. It's like
an
oil sands in the U.S. is a big deal. So okay. So Rosa, you're going to go talk to the tribal elders.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll say there are some couple hours away. The main thing you remember about it is it's the land of exiles, where if you have nowhere else to go, that's where you go, or you're just drawn there. So you don't remember much else about it.
No wonder someone with a PhD in archaeology is drawn there.
Yeah. So.
One thing.
Yeah.
Either you guys don't sleep there.
I really wouldn't.
It's not on my list. Story. It's a kid story, but you know what? Everything else is lining up. Just don't sleep there.
Okay.
Sounds good.
I actually do like camping, but I feel like that's probably not the right place.
Okay. No. All right, so Duke, you're going to be researching Granite Orion, I guess, just reading the case files?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you going to go out and buy padlock and chain first?
I don't really want to leave this thing alone right now.
All right. So you just set it in the windowless conference room, and then you study the case files with your gun by your side, I assume.
Just put it on top of it, it'll be fine. Yeah.
Maybe give the shelf a kick every once in a while and see if anything responds.
Okay.
I like the fact that I've not been present for any of the the clear indications of insanity in my coworker.
Okay, so that's interesting. All right, so you start digging away. He is all right. Go ahead and give me a. Let's see here. Let me look at your sheet. See what you could use to if there is. You could use criminology to research it, or bureaucracy. But they'll each give you different results. You could roll both.
Okay. Go with bureaucracy first. No, that's a 86. That's a fail.
All right, there's documents there. Yep, definitely
you got
stuff.
86.
And criminology, you got 48 out of 50.
Okay. Well, you read that newspaper clipping and some things. And, yep, that... Oh, and you figured out... You have an idea what's in the box, so go ahead and give me that, the metal cabinet. So give me a sand check.
Oh, fuck. Please. Pass. 37.
Okay. Well, it's not... It must have... That body couldn't have. It doesn't smell. Why doesn't it smell? Well, it's probably just bones. I would hear the bones clanking around. Well, they must have taken it out. It must be empty. It must be just a bunch of.
Oh, God. Out of character, you guys got to get back here before I burn this place down.
So, Delta Green could not cover up the fact that two hikers killed each other in 1957 on that land, which. But what they did, they could cover up with the circumstances of it. They made it sound like they just got angry at each other and, you know, one stabbed the other and the other then killed himself. That's not what happened. That's not what happened at all. The two men that went out there who were just outdoorsmen, they were just friends, and they it was a new, practically, you know, unheard of hiking area, very scenic. Everyone seemed to, you know, no one seemed to be, there weren't any roads going out there, there was no park. Everyone just kind of ignored it. And then they went out there and they hiked and they camped there overnight. And then that night, they don't know exactly what happened, but one of the hikers, he woke up and he just viciously murdered his friend of many years. They served in World War II together. And then when the park ranger found him, and then started, you know, setting the desert on fire. started setting.
What?
When people from the town saw the black smoke, they went out there. The sheriff and another and the mayor were there. They were the first to find him, and they saw him. And they describe that you read the interviews, and it's kind of hard to describe that he was different, physiologically different. It was human meat, but in a different shape. And they kind of indicate it was still able to talk, and it was trying to scuttle, try to crawl into a bunch of rocks. And it said, the ocean, where is it? And then it kind of died, and they kind of dug it out. There's no photos. It says there was a photo, but someone burned it apparently, or it's missing. But there's a Delta Green came in, swore everyone to secrecy because the sheriff was panicking, and the guy also mentioned CTHULHU, which apparently triggered Delta Green getting nature. Or getting involved. There's just one word. There's just two words there. Have Dr. Kinnison autopsy the starfish.
Group text. Hurry up.
So that takes you hours. And you look there. You think you hear a thump coming from it. Give me Sancho.
02, pass.
Okay. Whew. You're holding on. You're fine. It's got to be dead.
Settling. It's settling.
Opening my second pack of cigarettes for the morning.
Oh, no, this is taking you hours.
Yeah, okay.
Hours trying to, with your failed bureaucracy check, you try to decipher a bunch of other documents all about land and real estate and trust offices and shit like that, but you couldn't make heads or tails of them. And then you dive into the interviews of the sheriff and the mayor and some other people who you're not sure why they're involved. And that's when you finally find that interview, and they mention that, like, have Dr. Kinnison autopsy the starfish.
Could I roll law to see if there's anything else I could dig up about this?
Sure.
Fuck, 95. Nope.
You're not really, you're a little distracted. You're just
reasonably sure starfish are against the law.
What's in there? What is that? That can't be a starfish. No. What the fuck? No. It's got to be one of the hikers, right? It's got to be. No, it can't be that. What the fuck is in there? Yeah, it's kind of distracting. So, meanwhile, while this is going on, let's see here. Atherton, you get a hold of Spencer Lee, and Mr. Lee calls you right back. He's a younger man. He says, "Hi, you're the guy with the EPA, right?"
Yeah. Hi, how you doing? Sorry if I got your boss on.
No, hey, it's fine. Actually, Yeah, are you familiar with it? Here, can you meet me? And he gives you an address, Clovis. There's a retirement home outside of town. There's somebody who could actually explain this, why the fuck they hid this. I mean, this is worth a lot of money. You think they would want to have be rich and everything? I think it's the mayor.
I mean, some people have, you know, people got personal desires, not always money. But yeah,
yeah,
sure.
Meet me here at this retirement home. If you're a government guy, you could probably convince them to let me talk to him. Questions.
I'll talk to him. I'll be there in a little bit. I just gotta write a couple reports first, and I'll be on, or finish up a report I'm working. I'll be on my way.
Great. I'll be waiting for you in the parking lot.
All right. I shoot off a couple of messages to tell the others where I'm going to be, and I guess head that way.
Okay. So you head there.
I want to send another message real quick to Duke and ask about if he can look into who Dr. Kinson was, like this the person he mentioned about the autopsy thing. See if we can.
Okay. He doesn't reply immediately. Yeah. He seems to be.
Do they get the hurry up text yet, or is that?
They will in a little bit.
Okay.
That's fine.
You get to the Shady Sands retirement home. It's a
Shady Sands. Good.
It's a kind of generic kind of retirement home. There's a younger guy there. Corporate casual dress. He introduces himself as Spencer, and he is, talking quite fast, heavily drinking an energy drink as he was waiting for you. So, also heavily caffeinated.
Right.
And he is, it's really great to that the EPA is being a lot more proactive now. I mean, I know you're regulating everything, but . The fact that you're not sitting in your ass just trying to cover it and everything, that you're out here in the field. That's great. That's great, man. I'm glad.
Morning. Good to meet you. Yeah, thank you. I take pride in my job. So what's the deal? Who are we talking to here?
This is a mayor. He was the former mayor of this town, and then he started working for the State Trun Land Office. So his name is Anthea Silva. And he, let's see here. I'm sorry. So all I can figure out is, people knew that there were oil sands on here for a long time, but people in these results were never made public or hidden or kind of, and the land's legal status was always kept sort of ambiguous. So that no company could rent it, or it couldn't be turned over to the national parks. It was kind of purposely kept in this limbo so that nobody would use it, or nobody would even realize it was available to use. And Anthony was one of the guys behind it, and I kind of want to know why, because it's worth a lot of money, and... I mean, maybe it wasn't worth much money back then. Maybe they didn't want to have a big, ugly... I don't know. It's weird. I mean, they could have used it for asphalt back then, at least. Mm. I mean, that's what they did with oil sands before, oil prices changed what they were. I don't know. I'm hoping maybe you, as Mr. Government Man, can be a little more persuasive. If I can tell my boss if there's any... I just need to know if there's any legal roadblocks we have to be aware of. I think we're in the clear now. Like, outside of this archaeological dig, we can have it... The governor, a little while ago, wanted to privatize a bunch of land, which led to this whole thing in the first place.
Right.
So, public-private partnership. Huh? Yeah! All right. Let's do this. So... Both of you go in. The nurse is like, "Hello, can I help you?" And then Spencer looks at you.
Oh yeah, my name's Agent Atherton. I'm with the EPA. I was here because I was hoping to get a chance to talk to Mr. Silva about some just particular issues with land deeds and some other things going back to his tenure as mayor and the ways after. Is he able to talk today, or?
Give me persuade.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, no. 70 out of 50.
I'll check. And she looks, the nurse looks very put upon. she does not appreciate having to actually do work. So she slowly and reluctantly gets up and goes.
I'm not the most charming person in the world. I get that.
So as you're waiting, there's an old woman there. She kind of wheelchairs over here. Are you from the government?
Yeah.
Ah, you gonna be part of them people that gonna keep the commies away?
No, I just am part of the people who make sure that nobody accidentally spills oil in a public park or something.
What? Oh, yeah. Oh, so you're not with them Delta folks, are you?
Sorry, what?
Them Delta folks?
I don't know if I know what you mean. Has somebody else been here already?
Tony, he keeps talking about them. Hmm. Says we all owe it to the Deltas. Hmm. So
that's interesting. Must be. I glance over at.
He is checking his phone.
Yeah. Okay.
He does not pay attention. Let's see here. What are you gonna?
Yeah. Oh boy.
Well, no, I already knew Delta Green was involved out here. Although an old man flapping his lips about it isn't great.
No, it's not. Remember, you have to deny. You know, no one, the public can never know of the group. Tie up all loose ends. That's kind of a long-standing order.
Yeah. Yeah. That's good. That's something else to worry about.
All right. So
you know where she sleeps.
Yeah, that's what I'm worried about.
The nurse comes back. He's available to see visitors. This way. So she leads you into a courtyard in the middle of the building. And there is Mr. Tony Silva, Anthony Silva, who is, you know, sort of, actually, oh no, it's not in the courtyard, it's actually to his room. Mm. And as you go in there, there is a big green triangle, crudely drawn on a piece of paper, stuck to a bulletin board on the wall, and the word Delta written on it. And so, yeah, he is there. What are you going to? He looks exact. You're here with them, right? You're
actually,
here.
Before we go in, I'm gonna to ask Mr. Lee if I can have a run on my own first.
That's definitely persuade.
Okay. 44. Yes.
Success. All right. Like, he gets a call, or he gets a text.
I persuade so well, he gets a phone call to...
No, as he gets a phone call, he realizes, look, just give me the results, right? Then I can, actually, I can take a break. You could just email me what you get. I'll leave.
Okay.
I realize I don't like being around old people, so I will leave now.
I gave him an opportunity to be to use ageism and leave.
Yeah, to play hooky. So he, Spencer, skates off, and you are alone with him. You're here. You're finally here from the government.
You were
Delta, right?
Maybe we should tone that part down a little bit, sir. I don't know how things used to work. I'm closing the door.
No one listens to an old crazy old man anymore.
Yeah, I
think I got dementia. I remember it. I remember everything.
All right.
I mean, this is just. I've been trying to contact you for a while, I guess, because you want the sit rep. Sit rep is. I set it up so that no one could touch it legally. It should be fine.
All right. What does that mean? Because there are people who are trying to touch it legally, and I need to know how to not let that happen.
You can't let them. You can't let them. Did you read the interview, the dossier?
I got some people going through the old paperwork right now, but everything's in motion. So I need to just give me what you have. I need to know bare bones. What are we looking at, and what did you do with the paperwork? And what did you do to the paperwork? What can I do?
Okay. Gary, give me one more. You can give me human.
Alrighty. 34 out of 70.
Alright. He is clearly haunted by what he has seen. And he has been playing the part of the good soldier as long as he can. But he is, you know, not doing... It's been a burden. It's not been well. It's not been easy for him. It's left him, a poor shell of a man. You know, this is probably the only involvement he's had with Delta Green. He's probably what they call a friendly. You know, someone used for some monster. He's like, oh, keep watching that old site. Make sure no one uses it. Bye. And, no mission day. Never. No relief. So this has just been crushing him for decades. So. Right. That's, you know, maybe a happy ending for you. Best possible outcome. He says those hikers, it wasn't natural what happened to him. I was one of the first people on the scene. I saw it wasn't a him anymore. It was an it. It crawled into the rocks. We got it out, though. Cut my hands up kind of bad, but we did it because I just couldn't believe it used to be human. But... you know, they say, I talked to some of the guys, some of the people, some of the, you know, the natives, they said it was a bad place, bad dreams, you know?
Yeah.
So we figured out how no one would ever get it, and we just made sure no one, and, you know, every once in a while we'd drive by and make sure, sometimes the hippies came.
Yeah.
In the 60s, we ran them off, broke one of their legs.
What did you mean it was crawling into the rocks? What do you mean?
Oh God. It was. All right. Do you want to,
I'm going to back off on that one. Okay. Take your time. That's fine. We'll worry about what I need to worry about right now.
You can't let them be on there. There's something in there. It's something. It ain't whatever it is. I think I know.
Look, don't worry about it. You don't need to explain what it is.
You can't let anybody sleep there. You can't let anybody build there.
Okay.
Some things should just stay buried.
Look, Mr. Silva, I want to tell you one thing straight off before we go any further. This isn't yours to carry anymore. This is mine.
Persuade.
Alrighty. Let's go for... Please again, yay! Yeah, 19.
Okay, he seems a little relieved by that.
I'm here to take whatever help, whatever information you can give me. Okay, this is. You don't need to put up signs. You don't need to try and call. I'm here, and after I leave, it's mine. I carry it. Do you understand?
Mm-hmm. You know, there was a time after. Vietnam, they were getting rid of a bunch of military surplus, and we talked some favors in, and we kind of rerouted some of that because we thought maybe we'd need it. I'm not sure why. You know, some people try to make a commune out there. I don't know why. Well, I know why. Well, we thought we might need it, so we put a lot of stuff out there in the desert. I don't think anyone's found it.
You put weapon caches out there?
There's one. It ain't, well, not on the site itself. Ooh. But, there's this, there's this crazy guy who built, I don't understand his head. He took a bunch of cars and made them into, like, an arrangement, you know, and we buried it under that, you know. It's a car hinge.
They made, like, a bunker?
Yeah, well, no, it's like standing stones, but with,
the cars.
Yeah, cars. So, yeah. Anyways. So, yeah, that was us. We put a bunch of weapons under there. It's under the caddy that's spray-painted blue and yellow.
All right. The most important thing I need to know, though, is legally, paperwork-wise, what did you do and how can... And is I need to find a way to keep this from having people wanting it.
He kind of drifts for a little bit.
All right.
There's Eddie in the state trust office. You should talk to him. Eddie Bowman.
Okay. All right.
Well, I will. You've been a great help. It sounds like you guys were you prepared things as best you could, and everything you've done is greatly appreciated. And like I said, this is all on me now. I am responsible for taking care of things. You don't have to carry this anymore. But one thing I will ask is you can't talk about the organization anymore. You can't tell people. You know, ours is not the glory. Ours is just getting the job done. All right.
Oh, I thought I could. Oh, yeah, I forgot that.
It's all right.
Okay.
You focus on taking care of you. The world out there, that's my job.
Okay. All right. So you leave. You didn't incite. You didn't cause him to have a heart attack. Good job. So let's see here, Rosa.
Yep.
So you head.
I do like as I'm leaving. I take down his little delta sign as I'm like after I finish that speech and be like, okay.
All right. Yeah. He seems all right. He's kind of like, oh.
Okay.
you head to some tribal lands.
The closer the better.
Yeah. There is a... Let's see here. Let's see here. Let's see. There is an old man, Psych, people call him, who sits at home. You know, he's kind of a homebody, obviously. But Psych is a, he's a storyteller. He knows a lot. He knows all the legends, he knows all the folk tales, so he'd be the person to talk to,
okay.
You can drive out to him with a bottle of, he actually really appreciates people buying stuff, he's trying to, what is his business? I would say I don't know. You think of some gift to get him. I'm not sure. Would be good. You can take him out to dinner. At the Red Lobster.
All right.
Because it's the fanciest place in town. that's seafood, maybe.
Childhood right there. Ooh.
Yeah. So you can take him out to see Red Lobster for lunch, actually. Okay. Let him end in order after that. And then, you tell him how are you framing this request for information? Is it just curiosity or professional or, like, why are you asking him now? He'll tell you, but, how much do you want to hide from him?
Well, the cat's already out of the bag that there is an excavation in Clovis, or near Clovis.
Yeah.
So I'm just going to frame it. I'm an archaeologist, and I'm just trying to collect some oral history about the region. Okay. And as, you know, as a child, I heard a story that I don't completely remember, and I was thinking that you might have a more complete recollection.
Okay, we are pretty honest, pretty straightforward. And with your language abilities, you don't have to roll. He knows you and he trusts you, so he opens up to you. It's a story I don't like telling, especially to outsiders, because it seems to. I don't know. It doesn't really fit in with any other of our. Stories, any of our tales, any of what we believe. I never really understood it myself. But if you found a place, if you think this is the land of exiles, it doesn't make sense in any framework of our legends. Anytime there was a criminal, someone who just didn't, I mean, not just a criminal, but like, a tainted criminal, someone who was
really bad,
really bad. and if he wasn't killed outright, you know, like if we were afraid to kill him, people were, if the war, you know, if the tribe was afraid to kill him or he was just too cunning, he would be exiled. We would kill him on sight, so he had to flee. And it just always turned out that those exiles would wind up in one particular place. And people who went by that area, they would find other exiles from, you know, as far away as the Great Plains or even farther. There were never more than one or a few, a handful of men there at any time. But there always seemed to be at least one hermit or at least one person there. And that became known as the Land of Exiles. And it was just known to avoid it. And it was believed that people forgot where it was exactly because, or maybe they just didn't want to tell me where it was. So I never knew exactly where it was. But the only other thing I know about it is that there were bad dreams, that there was a somewhat, you would be, it was not just a bad dream, but you would be dreaming someone else's dream. Someone or a giant was sleeping under the land, and if you slept there, you would have his dream. And that maybe I don't know if it was explicitly connected to the land, why the people were drawn there, why the criminals were drawn there, but maybe it does. Maybe that's why. So the giant was not good. It was something about it was wrong. If it's this place, I mean, if you're finding an archaeological site with a lot of things from other cultures, maybe there is some basis. Maybe that was. It doesn't sound like it would support life. It was, you know, I don't know how people live there if they couldn't, you know, roam very far to hunt or. I don't think there's even any water near it. It's a very dry area, so yeah. I don't know. It's a very bad place. All I know is. You don't sleep on it, and you beware of people who do, because they will have seen the dreams of the giant.
And I suppose that's. Do you know when the last people, our people exiled out there were? You know how many generations ago?
I think people were always. I mean, when I was a child, I heard of. A man who killed his wife, you know, after having a strange dream, and then fleeing, and people just assume he went to the land of the exiles. And Psyche himself is, you know, let's see here, probably 70 years old at least. So we're talking about 60 years ago, it was a minor story. People only brought it up when you brought up, oh, well, he's a really bad guy. He should go to the exile place. You know, he should go to the land of the exiles. It was that, and that was about it. And people just kind of assumed it was. People didn't think much else about it.
Well, thank you very much, Elder. I get another glass of wine.
Okay.
All right. Goes down fast.
All right. Fair enough. At this time, both of you got the text message from Duke saying to hurry up.
So, all right. I'll get some cheddar biscuits to go.
Of course. So the two of you head out. I guess everyone's reconvening at Santa Fe.
Yeah. Santa Fe seems reasonable.
Okay. So it takes you a few more hours. By this time, it's late afternoon. And you're back at the Santa Fe office, Consolidated Synergy. So you let yourself in. Duke, you can do one more thing before they show up.
Okay.
One research action.
I failed looking into the murders.
No, you succeeded in the murders. You failed in the bureaucracy for the land stuff.
Could I give that another go?
Dr. Kinson.
You could try and... Yeah, you did see that reference to a Dr. Kinson. Actually talk to Holden and give him an update on your findings.
Oh, yeah, we should probably
definitely do that.
Yeah, I was going to wait until the three of us got together, just an info dump.
Yeah. All right.
Well, I mean, you can... Yeah, okay. That's fair. Well, you could ask Holden for information on Kinson.
Okay, yeah, I'll do that.
Okay. So you do that. A short while later, you get a message. You get an encrypted file back. And you have the passkey to decrypt it, uncrypt it, whatever.
Other crypted?
Yeah. And it is Agent Kinson, real name, Dr. Let's see here.
Kamarov!
Kamarov, no. let's see here.
Steve Kamarov.
Dr. Daryl, let's see here, Schmidt. Dr. Daryl. Yeah.
Nice.
New York Coroner's Office. Delta Green agent, expertise, and it gives a scientific name, something sapiens, something 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 sapiens.
Is it?
It's not Homo sapiens. It's something else.
Is it HBO?
Actually, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh God.
Also, there is a deceased died in 2007, but there is an overview of his expertise. It looks like he was referred to an Orion, Granite Orion, but due to other commitments could not make it, or that seems to be incomplete. There's also a reference to a green box where his medical records are held, which is in New York, unfortunately. But you could ask Holden to go get those for you if you thought it had information on him. But it looks like he was a Delta Green medical expert who, you know, cut up weird things for them to look at. And he never got to New Mexico to look at this thing because of other priorities. And just, you know, there's some times where he just spent some downtime, you know. Mm-hmm. He just had to, you know, recover.
Rest.
And then he just died. Well, it says officially missing, but Delta said he definitely died.
I see. Missing in the disappeared sense.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, retired.
Legally, he is missing.
Alright.
Goody.
Delta Green confirms, confirmed dead. At body destroyed.
That makes me feel better, that last part.
Actually, yeah. I mean,
as per protocol, actually it says. Body destroyed as per protocol.
Oh, I did not know I'd signed up for that.
Well, my burial plans
are
complete.
That's what you get. That's what you get by the time Atherton and Rosa show up. So you're all back in Consolidated Synergy. There's a bunch of boxes. There's like five or six boxes of documents. And there's a metal cabinet there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and Duke with some pretty heavy bags around his eyes at this point.
Actually, hold on. Let me roll luck real quick to see if I remember to get chains.
Oh, yeah. So, you haven't slept for a day now. I actually already had you. I'll just say it costs you one more willpower to stay up this
time. Okay. I was rolling high and I rolled 87. I did buy you some chains.
Oh, good. Yeah. So you can chain that up if you want.
I immediately go to the shelf and do that. Probably asking Atherton to hold up the shelf while I wrap the chain around it.
I do so.
I explain while this is happening. Like, so you're gonna want to take a peek at all that's going on. This is something recovered from the site. It was waiting for an autopsy, and
I think Mr. Silva, the former mayor I talked to, I think he probably saw whatever we'd see in the box if it were still alive. And
it's moving around. Yeah.
I look from him to the crate or to the cabinet and back.
I kick it.
Nothing happens.
Ah, little fucker.
You didn't. I'll say at this point I walk in.
All right, yeah. So Rose is in there too.
So
that's new.
Yeah. We might want to. I don't know. We might want to.
What did you do with those two other handguns you got?
They're on the table next to a couple empty packs of cigarettes.
Huh? Yeah. There's two new handguns. Two revolvers.
Drop pieces.
They're in the green box. You guys know how to shoot?
Yeah. I've had.
I show you my Rattler gun.
Nice.
It's only a 38.
Wait, you're what?
It's a gun for shooting rattlers.
Oh, okay.
I hand you a 44 and be like, yeah, you might want this.
Which you? Oh, okay.
Or whoever wants it, but yeah.
There's a 44 and a 38. They're both revolvers. If you have a high firearm skills, you recognize these are really old guns. They're like 50, 60 years old.
Yeah, might want to. I mean, I got a 50. Is that high enough?
You don't know the exact model number or whatever, but they've also, you can tell both the serial numbers have been burnt, melted off with acid.
I mean, if they've been in the, like, there's no way of knowing how long they've been in that green box, you might want to take a look at them.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
They're very serviceable, actually. They were cloth with oil, so, yeah. That looks like they'll fire fine, assuming the bullets in them are.
All right, well, I mean, as far as what I picked up goes, there's apparently whoever worked the 57 job left behind a cache of weapons. So aside from these, we may have some other stuff we can find later. I also got to see if there's an Ed Bowman at the land office. I'm hoping he's not going to be someone who's retired for years, and see if I can pick up maybe ways of getting the developers out. What do you guys got?
Yeah, talked with a tribal elder. The natives around here have known that the target area is bad karma. Do not go there. Do not sleep there. Apparently, one rumor is about if you sleep there, you'll dream the dreams of a giant underneath the earth.
Do we have any idea how many of them have been sleeping there? I know we got the one. Are there more?
Oh, yeah. What was it? Four grad students and the professor?
Mm-hmm.
Great.
And we can't trust them. They've been sleeping there.
I mean, I wasn't thinking on it already, but... From what Silva said, it sounds like some sort of physical change happens. Aside from whatever dreams people are having, did everyone seem normal on the outside?
Yeah. I'm assuming that they all look normal.
If they looked physiologically different, I would have mentioned that. I'm not going to be that much of a dick. Oh, you didn't say you were looking at the people. You're not going to be that guy.
All right. Yeah, for now, they look normal. Yeah. As of this morning.
Okay. Duke, did you have a chance to look into that doctor?
Yeah, I was going to say, he's deceased. It looks like the program decided he needed to go away.
No good.
Yeah, he's got some documents stored up in New York, Green Box. We could probably get Holden to send him over, but it's going to be rough.
Well, I mean, does it sound like something we'll need for this, or is it just his stuff on, like, do you think it'll have records about our case?
He consulted with it, but he wasn't here. He never actually got to the site.
Oh, okay.
So he never did the autopsy on the thing?
Crap, I can't remember. Did?
No.
No. No, no, no. No, that's,
So they wanted him to do it, but
it was waiting for him.
So
they never did it. He probably would have burnt, disposed of the body after he.
Good. Well,
But I'm assuming neither of you has any kind of medical experience of any kind?
No.
Or scientific?
No.
If it's a skeleton, I can tell you if it's male or female.
Well, I'm reasonably sure that that's not going to be the information we're looking for.
I know, yeah.
We could talk to Holden, like, if we tell him that there's an unopened, like, unexamined, like, maybe he can put us in touch with someone, like, if the group has a medical examiner in this area that we can...
Okay.
I suppose, so, I'm definitely going to tell Holden about that and ask about it, and I guess everything else we got, we just want to collate a report this afternoon and send that off.
Yeah.
Let's see here, so... You're basically going to send a report to Holden of the current status of it. So
yeah.
Okay. Let's see here.
We have an unexamined thing that Dr. Kinson had been supposed to look at and never did. Are there other assets available?
Does Delta Green have Dr. Quincy?
You get a message back. Well, okay. So you spend the next few hours working. Doing this.
I should probably sleep.
Yeah. You don't look good. You should.
Are you sleeping in the office?
I really don't want to sleep, but yeah, I'm probably just going to sleep there.
Okay. Let's see here. All right, so, okay, so you send your message, your report, while Duke sleeps, and you stare at the thing in the you stare at the cabinet, the metal shelf. Both of you, give me sand checks.
Okay.
Wait, both of who?
Atherton and Rosa.
Oh, good.
The not sleeping ones.
Yeah.
All right.
I failed.
Op 3, I make it.
So Rosa, you failed.
Yep.
Thunk.
Did you hear that?
I'm assuming I didn't.
No.
No. We hear what?
God damn it. All right.
Actually, based on something that Rosa said, like once we sit down to work separately, I'm going to send another message to Holden asking if there's anything that I need to be, that like anything I need to keep an eye out for in my colleagues, just personal issue wise.
Okay.
Like anything that could compromise any, just, you know.
Okay. You get a message saying, I call me when you are alone.
Okay.
Okay. So so Rose, you two are working in the same room.
I'm thinking I'm going to set up my laptop's web camera to keep an eye on that cabinet.
Okay.
That's probably a good idea regardless.
Okay. So you do that. You have other rooms in this little office that you can use. You don't have to be crammed in the room with the cabinet.
I think I'm going to run out and get a bite to eat since someone's here to... Do you mind staying here and keeping an eye on Sleeping Beauty?
Yeah, I'll keep an eye on it.
All right. Do you want anything while I'm out? I mean, you got lobster, so I figured.
No, I'm good. Actually, no. Check that. Could I get some caffeine? I don't care.
I'm getting us. I'm gonna load up on coffee, like for making here. So I'll grab that.
Okay.
All right. So.
And then, of course, while I'm on the road, I'm calling up. Holden.
Multitasking.
All right. Holden answers. You're using encrypted smartphones.
Using the phone that he gave.
Holden says, I'm looking at the report. It says you have a specimen for examination.
Yeah, there was some in the green box. It was marked to be examined by this Dr. Kinson, who apparently never got around to it.
Yes. You are fortunate. There is a friendly at the University of New Mexico Prevention Research Center, which has a biohazard containment lab. We could open it up in a secure environment.
I like that way better than cracking it open in the office.
Yes. So you should, I will provide you a phone number to contact this person and arrange that. You should, I recommend you get this specimen examined as soon as possible.
Right.
And if you want, if you're concerned about any of your fellow agents, I would be concerned.
They haven't done anything that puts me too ill at ease, but I mean, you know, the professor did tell me that she's missing some time, and and Duke was talking about the freight moving around, which sounds, I don't know whether that's something that's in his head or something to be actually worried about.
If you feel that they are hallucinating or have lost contact with the reality, you should contact me immediately.
No prior, like nothing on record?
Rosa has had issues in the past. She is... I would be most concerned with if they experience sudden changes in behavior, a sudden output in artistic effort, if they begin to draw or sculpt anything related to...
I wasn't planning on disregarding those kind of behaviors already.
Oceanic subjects, things underneath the ocean,
okay.
You should assume they are hostile. They are no longer working in our interests. If they experience gross physiological change, especially in their necks, you should assume that they are hostile and must be terminated.
Is this something we need to look for at the people on site, I presume, as well?
Be aware. It appears from your report that this... whatever happens to people, this specimen is the result of that. So I would look to see what kind of autopsy that is. What that yields. But yes, I those people at the site, we'll have to, if we can get the names of all of them, we can monitor, the group can monitor them.
Right.
It might be better to let them leave.
Right.
So we can deal with them discreetly at a...
I don't have any way of doing it yet, but I mean, in my line, the easiest thing I would say is if we can get a report of toxic exposure, then we have all the cover we want to find out every single person and where they go. But but I don't know how to. I don't know if that's going to be doable or what yet. All but
you can give me an ecology check.
Further reports as warrants, I guess. Nope, 63 out of 40.
Okay, well, you can't think of a way to do that quickly, nothing comes to mind. You'd have to do more research.
Okay, but anyway, I just wanted to check in because I don't know. I got a vibe.
This is definitely escalating.
Definitely
more serious than we initially assumed.
Yeah, according to Hanani, they're pretty excited about the site, and I'm kind of worried about how much that's going to spread through the intellectual community, let's say.
Yes. We are expert. I will confirm with our own resources to try. We will attempt to discredit Dr. Forsyth and her efforts. Another possibility might be to allow, if we could discredit the archaeological dig, if you could plant evidence, something that could be faked to prove that it was not a real archaeological site or that she faked it, that would be beneficial to the group.
Crystal skulls and such?
Yes, something like that.
All right, well, we're back on the job more as it develops.
Okay. All right. So you head out, and that's what you get, and then you come back. Rosa, give me another sand check.
Oh, son of a bitch. Okay. Also, I'm not reading any of the texts alone, because that would be silly.
What are you doing?
Texting my spouse.
Okay. All right. Yeah, that's a good idea. Nice.
Trying to keep up those bonds. 21. Made it.
Okay. Yeah, you don't hear anything. You're just ignoring the job. Just trying to focus on that. The sink's broken again. Someone will have to fix it.
We've been here a day.
Yeah. It's been breaking. It's a crappy sink. The plumber did a terrible job fixing it the first time. So the UTAP is leaky. So, such is domestic life. Ha 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 ha. That's nice. So, all right. So you get back. You can contact. You have a contact now. It's just Grant. Grant is someone who works at the. Let's see here. Prevention Research Center, I think, for University of New Mexico. Where did I say it was called? Yes, Prevention Research Center, which has a biohazard containment lab.
All right, so, well, that'll be good.
For the rest of the night, can we read some of that stuff?
Yeah. I kind of want to go through the land documents and stuff that were...
All right, both of you can roll bureaucracy. All right, so you're not calling Grant yet?
No, actually, I'm guessing it's like evening night now?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm definitely calling Grant to set up something for as soon as possible. And I also want to send a message to the land office trying to get a hold of Ed Bowman, the name I got from Silva.
All right, bureaucracy check for Ed Bowman.
Okay. 28, made it.
Nice. He's dead.
Yeah, I figured.
He died of old age a couple years ago.
He died of heart stop, and that's all it says.
Let's see here. So, yeah, it's about 9, 10 o'clock right now. And you call up Grant. You hear a twitchy voice. Yes? Is this the group?
Yeah. Holden gave me...
Anything to serve. Ever since... Yeah, no, I'm here.
Take
a breath. We're good. But we got a sample, and we need a clean environment and someone who knows, you know, more than I do about biology to look at it.
You called the perfect time. The lab's going to be unoccupied until 7 a.m. How far are you? What's your ETA?
Well, we're in Clovis right now.
No, you're in Santa Fe.
Oh, sorry, we're in Santa Fe right now.
Which is an hour and a half, 90 miles away.
So. Okay, yeah, I guess I'll have to get, yeah, I guess I'll have to wake up what's-his-name and borrow his vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'm gonna make the appointment, and I'll be there in 2 hours.
I'll be waiting there. If you have any experts with you, I can perform any autopsy. I'm ready.
Okay.
So, all right, Duke, you wake up. You've had your little cat nap.
All right.
Yeah, sorry, Duke, but we got a line on someone to look inside the box, and I need to. You have the biggest vehicle.
All right, done. Grab some Everclear on your way back.
Okay. do either one of you want to come with, or
I'll come with.
Okay.
I guess I don't really want to leave that motion over to the shelf alone.
No, that's what I'm taking.
We're taking it.
Then we're all going.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Well, I guess we'll lock up and load the thing into the vehicle and head off to the university.
Okay. So what do you talk about on the way over? You got 2 hours to kill.
I'm going to talk about interesting net. Like, I am going to really try and avoid learning more about these people's personal lives. So I'm going to talk about interesting national parks in New Mexico because I'm there.
All right. Yeah, that's fine. So he's Atherton's clearly trying to distract.
If this ends up, you know, being resolved in a reasonable period of time, then I'm hoping to, you know, check out. There's a super volcano crater that's like. It's really interesting.
Human at 80 is he acting a little different, a little skittish around us?
All right, go for it. Roll.
29, pass.
He does seem to be a little more nervous. Maybe it's proximity to the metal cabinet.
Okay, nothing like too.
No, I mean even for me, I definitely
gotten under his skin, but like,
yeah, talking to Holden, I'm not as like worried about specifics about the two of you because all the stuff he gave me sounded more like if people are in proximity to the crazy shit stuff and not like things about you already.
Okay, I'm sure if I looked at the doctor too, we're all a little.
But after the last conversation that I had with Honani, I would prefer to keep things.
I just didn't want it to come up as a surprise.
Yeah. All right.
No, I'm going to keep that to myself. Okay, and we go.
Right. I will take that folder you got at the green box. Ooh, yeah. I'll read it by pen light.
Light reading on the way.
Got a multitask. All right, done.
Give me a bureaucracy check.
All right. 35 out of 60.
Okay. You can tell, there was a conspiracy among the sheriff, the mayor, and three officials at the State Trust Land Office that were essentially doing everything they can to make sure no one ever tried to seize this parcel of land or to develop it in any way or use it for anything. And they were very subtle at times, sometimes not so subtle. There is a mention of a welcoming party that the sheriff and the deputies gave for some hippies in the 60s that were trying to establish a commune there. It is not elaborated further. But it looks like they were all recruited into Delta Green as friendlies with the sole mission of keeping this land unoccupied. There are mentions of check-ins with the agency, those kind of stop by they stop after 1972.
Weird.
But they keep on doing it. That's about it. It's a lonely vigil. The thing is, they never told anyone else why they were doing this, so there was no one left to carry on the torch. So it was only a matter of time before someone would look into this land.
Well, I will let them know.
All right. So you pull into the Prevention Research Center, which is, let's see here. I don't know anything about it, but I just assume it's a biohazard lab.
It's a place. It's got lab stuff.
It's got, yeah. Let's see if there's any photos I can get of it. People. No biohazard labs. I just assume it has a biohazard lab. So there is.
We're really gonna make some NSA guys night with this.
Yeah. So there is a. Twitchy-looking guy, mustached, constantly looking around. Couldn't look more suspicious if he tried. Waiting for you inside the door. He unlocks it to let you in.
All right.
As you bring the dolly with you, so you can dolly the thing in. And he looks at it. Wait, this is it? It's in there?
Yeah.
God, any number of airborne. I mean, you didn't touch it, he notices the blood, the stained blood. Oh my God, were any of you cut?
I slipped when I was carrying it out.
Oh, let me see your hand.
He
grabs your hand and looks at it very closely. I'll have to draw blood samples later. It's better. We have to be sure, right?
Sure, boss.
I'm just here to do my duty, never again.
Operational security and everything.
I give them both a look.
You can give me anyone with human can give me a human roll.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, look at that.
Holy shit, a 99. God damn it.
Nope.
This guy seems trustworthy.
This guy's an operator. He's pro. You're fine.
He seems normal.
Did any of you make it?
No.
All three made it. All three of you failed. Nice.
He's just a hard worker.
Yep, he's just a hard worker. You're fine.
I have an 80. Damn it.
So, well, that means 4 out of 5 times you're fine. It's you go into the biohazard lab, and that's when you notice the nice Ithaca shotgun that's on the table. It says, just in case.
Yeah.
This has incendiary shells in it, so use it as a last resort. He takes out another shotgun. This one has solid slug shots, so you know, in case we things get really out of hand.
Okay.
So,
nice. Okay.
Yeah. But
well, you're the expert.
Yeah. Yeah. All three of you can give me law or bureaucracy checks.
21 made it. Bureaucracy.
Okay.
I made law too.
40 out of 60.
Okay.
I failed on my law.
Okay. Well, those of you who make it, you realize you cannot get caught here. If right. anything happens, you have to get the fuck out. If you were caught here, you're done. Like, you're out of the group. Okay. You're gonna be. Yeah. Like, you have no good reason to be here. No.
We're gonna be keeping an eye on the door.
Yeah.
Actually.
Yeah.
Gonna,
oh, the building gonna, is abandoned. The building's empty.
I'm gonna move the car. Okay. So it's
actually I'm also making that realization. I'm gonna ask Grant. Like, there aren't. Are there cameras here? Is there?
Yeah. Of course.
Okay, what are we doing?
Oh, no, don't worry, I got them. They're on loop right now.
All right, well, he seems like a trustworthy operator. From
oh, yeah, he's a trustworthy operator. You're fine. He's got your back.
Yeah, he does.
So.
Oh, God, this is how we die.
No. All right, Grant asks if any of you want to go in inside with him. Is he suiting up in his hazmat suit?
I'll go. I mean, I'm not exceptionally well trained, but I know
you better put a hazmat suit on. So yeah.
I know a decent amount about biology. Like okay. I can assist if you.
I will observe from out here.
Are you taking a shotgun with you there, Atherton?
I mean, well, he's our guy here, so should one.
Well,
should
he laid them outside the room in case one of you wanted them. So.
Okay.
Oh yeah, I grab one.
Okay. Well, so which one are you grabbing? The incendiary or solid slug?
I'll leave the incendiary for whoever's inside.
All right, Atherton. That's great.
Okay, fine.
yeah. All right, so you go in with the metal cabinet. You wheel it in there.
Well, I mean, would you want slugs instead? I mean, I figured fire rounds.
Yeah.
It's more of a cone.
Your fire rounds aren't going to be, like, there is, like, a thick glass partition, you know, to
yeah.
so you can
people. All right, now I'll take the incendiary gun in.
Okay. So you go in. There's the metal cabinet. You remove the chain because you had the lock for that.
Right.
But then there's the thick lock on it already. But never fear, Grant has bolt cutters. Do you want him to cut it or do you want to cut it?
No, Grant's got it. I trust him. I got the gun.
Okay. So you're pointing the gun at it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, no, I have the gun at rest, but it is ready.
Okay, it is ready. All right, so he pulls removes the rusted, you know, heavy lock from it and removes it, plinks it on the table by him, and then just heavily, this place, it's almost rusted shut. He has to really strain to get it open.
I should have got some WD-40. That's
and then he just... Well, the WD-40 compromised this. So it's a cabinet, so it's like a metal shelf that you can close, kind of like a gun locker or something like that.
Yeah.
So it's lying flat on the table with the door pointing up towards the ceiling. So you open the doors up, but it's like pitch. It's like who's going to peer over the side to look in?
Well, I'm in the room with him, so I guess I'm going to look too.
Okay. So, oh, you're letting Grant look first, or you're going to look at the same time?
I figured we'd look at the same time.
All right, the two of them look in. You two outside the room cannot look in yet because they have to whatever's in there. It has to come out of that one way or the other. All right, give me a sand check.
All right.
Grant actually makes his sand check.
24. I also make my sand check.
All right. Both of you lose one. Do you have a disorder? I don't think you do.
Oh, I'm you know, I'm just doing my thing.
So you don't have to roll for your disorder triggering. Grant does, though.
No.
he makes it. He's holding his shit together. So you see it. You lose your 1 point of sand. This is definitely unnatural. So it's like a... It is shaped like a starfish, but it's like semi-dried. It's still somehow somewhat fluid, almost glistening.
How big is it?
side to side. It's a human that was shaped into a starfish with the head at the center, heavily disfigured. It looks, the eyes are just empty sockets. It's heavily dried and desiccated, but there's parts of it are glistening.
So it's like the head has somehow shifted down to the middle of the torso.
Yeah. The hand, there are just like different two fingers per like a appendage of the stars, and it's just stuck side to side inside there. If you want to autopsy it, you're going to have to take it out.
Okay.
Well, I like that pause there. Like, oh fuck.
You got a fucking cowboy up. All right.
Give me a strength times 5.
We're in hazmat suits. Strength times 5 is 55. Let's see.
All right.
Ot 1.
Ot 1. You make it. So you pull it out your half. Grant does not make it. He rolled a 97. So he slips and drops it and almost. And fortunately, he lets it go and does not puncture his suit because there are sharp. The teeth are. All the human teeth are, are aligned on the outer edges of the new limbs to help dig in. And they're all just. But you do get to see a good side of it. Both of you give me sand checks.
Yep.
Okay.
79. I failed.
34. I made it.
So who failed? Rosa?
Yep.
Okay, Rosa, roll sand again.
Shit.
Roll that beautiful sand footage.
That's a symbol. Okay, 12, so I made it.
Okay, you do lose 5, though. This is a D6 because this is horrific as shit. This is, you don't become amnesiac, so that's good. And
who are you?
Yeah, so you still keep your memories. Duke, you did lose 1 point of sanity because this is a 1-1-6. So go ahead and give me a roll to see if you just get fucking angry.
Alrighty. Ooh, 27. No.
Okay. You keep your shit together.
All right, everybody keeps their shit together.
So, Rosa, you can just run away or curl.
I'm going to fast walk out of the room.
All right, you fast walk out of the room to the bathroom and just start, emptying. That lobster, you really regret having that lobster.
I didn't have to be Red Lobster.
All right, so you make one more check and you manage to get it out of the thing. Actually, let's see if he crit fails. Nah, he doesn't crit fail, so.
Did I roll again?
It's heavy. It weighs as much as a desiccated human. So it weighs like it's very dense, even though it's much smaller than a human. Grant starts to work on it, cutting it up.
Can I roll biology just like see if I?
Oh yeah, definitely roll biology.
Good. Thanks for that excitement. 58. I do not make it.
Okay. What the fuck? What the ever?
Well, this is all. This is all pretty fucked.
Yeah, no, it's not even possible. No human, like the thing is, it would be one thing. You recognize that this thing actually was. This is not like something that was done to a corpse.
This happened while, like it lived a while after this.
Yes. But you can't learn anything else. So
it's still alive.
Let's see if Grant does anything. So this is, of course, going to take a couple hours. But let's see here. Grant actually learned some things.
Good.
He steps back after a while, and he works on it. It's like, I can't believe it. It's not dead. It's in suspended animation.
Hibernating?
Yes, it's certain sea creatures were able to live for great periods of time, essentially going into hibernation, and it's like a semi-adapted for oceanic, life. It's like a human decided to evolve into, and just will. I can't even explain how the mechanism of it is.
That's probably for the best.
But. It would be. It's quite weak. It's nearly dead. It was clearly, not. It was. But the mouth of the vocal box, it's still there.
Are there
the brain is still, I think, intact.
Are there any wounds from however they subdued it in the first place?
I think so, yeah. I mean, I've only made superficial cuts into it. I don't know your mission, and maybe I don't want to, but... Do you want to talk to it?
No.
We could strap it down, and you could talk to it.
As far as we're going into this mission, after we get as much knowledge as we can from this, we need to disassemble and burn it.
Okay, so I have to kill it then. We have to.
You all right?
Okay. Give me a human roll.
19.
Okay. Yeah. No. This is actually surprisingly familiar to Grant, but not in a. I mean, not in a good way.
Right.
How could it be?
But we came to the right person.
Yeah. Let's see if he makes a sand check. Because he's the one who's going to have to stab it in the brain.
Do you want me to?
Well, you're not a trained. Yeah, you could.
If it's safer that it'll get done for him doing it, then definitely.
Well, you might destroy, important tissue.
Right. Okay.
But he makes a sand check. So he holds his shit together as he, finally, the blood and just viscera ooze out of it as he takes the drill into its brain and kind of cores it.
Where is its brain?
In the head, in the human head.
Okay, so it is in the. It is analogous where the head moved to, the brain is there.
Yeah, imagine if a human was made out of, Play-Doh, and you just shaped it into a starfish, but you were just pushing parts around.
I figured. As one does.
As one does. So he works on it for a few more hours, and he kind of is talking to himself and just the three of you, it's all grueling. That's one, let's hear, if you guys stay, it's another willpower, I assume. Rosa doesn't have to because she just kind of out. She's I don't think Rosa would go voluntary. You would have to force her to go back into that room.
No.
Yep.
I ask Duke to check on her every once in a while.
Okay. Yeah, I would be. Yeah.
Okay.
So before dawn, he's like, "All right, I've learned as much as I can. It will take some time." To correlate it, what do you want to know? It looks like it could shoot it in the head like a human if you encounter another one of those. It's actually probably less dangerous than a normal human would be. It's not, at least on dry land in the ocean, it would be much more dangerous. Okay. But what did you want to know?
All right. There's something I need to tell you about this particular find.
Uh huh.
I don't know what further, just to see if there's anything else you can knock out of this, but I feel like the hibernation thing kind of takes care of this already. This has been in a locker since 1957.
Oh God. Oh God. Well, that actually makes sense. That if it was in a cool environment, it wasn't. We could have preserved fluids better. And if it was out, I assume you got it somewhere out in the desert, somewhere here in the state.
Yeah.
The cabinet has, desert dirt on it.
Okay. Well, so, what I'm gonna need, aside from knowing its mobility issues and knowing where its brain is crucial information. But I do think, doing the blood tests on, actually you should probably, before we leave, if we can get blood draws from the other two of us that have been near this thing.
Of course. I have blood, it takes time to run tests on its blood.
Right, that stuff, do you have a drop box that you can get things to Holden?
Yes, I have a method of contacting him.
Okay, what you've given us thus far I'm hoping we don't run across a live one, but otherwise, knowing if this is viral, if there's anything else we need to know as far as containment, anything that you can find out through your analysis, get it to Holden and he'll get it to us.
Okay. High or low?
High.
Okay. All right, what do you tell him? Anything else?
Well, we need to... Now we need to find some way to get rid of this. I'm thinking step one is probably we need to bag it up and, like, bleach it or something, and then we need to take it out of the desert and burn it.
I have an incinerator. There's an incinerator.
Oh, that is so much easier. Thank you. Yeah.
Thank God.
Okay, all right. I assume you watch him do it and you make sure he puts it in, right?
Yeah.
Okay. You incinerate it. It's quite dead. Wasn't dead before. That's a warning for you. I assume everybody kind of wants to get some sleep after that.
Yeah.
Oh, God, yes.
All right, so...
How about we just grab a motel here in town and then drive back to the office in the morning?
Okay. Well, it's morning now. Yeah.
Or, I guess. Okay, do we want to crash here before we go anywhere else?
It's probably better to sleep in the day.
All right. That's fair. So you all do that. That's another day. You actually all of you give me sand checks.
I knew it was coming.
It comes to crumbling.
41, I pass.
94. Oh, I super pass.
I failed.
Doc's going down hard.
All right. Rosa, you two wake up well before Rosa does. You do sleep about 8 hours, though. You're just utterly exhausted. So you restore your willpower all but one. But Rosa, you only restore 1 point of willpower. You have troubled sleep. It's not fun. And because you aren't on there, but you wonder if you can ever dream again, if it's ever safe to dream. So it's hard to get yourself to will yourself to go to sleep. So let's hear 8 a.m. to, so it's about 4 or 5 p.m. by the time you guys wake up. So what do you want to do next? You have information. The dig is still proceeding along. So
I think maybe we should get some eyes on the site.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean,
could we get a drone?
I think that's
that would definitely be requisition or stealing shit for Delta Green. You could ask Delta Green to do a flyby of it, but that's only going to give you a still image of it. If you want continuous surveillance, you're going to have to figure out another solution. U.S. Marshal would be the only one with a law enforcement ability to really ask for that, and you'd have to have a good reason to do that. Or you could, of course, you could lie. You could always say, oh, I think a fugitive is going to that area. But that would be, a negative to your check. So that would probably be criminology or bureaucracy minus 20.
And that would put me at a 40.
Let me double check on the rules, because this is exactly covered in Delta Green, the role-playing game.
Yeah, marshals aren't good for requisitions. They're like the brokest agency.
Let's see here. It's also you'd have to do it now or soon. So that's an additional negative 20.
Yeah, it's at a 20%. I don't think I'm gonna.
Yeah.
I just don't. I don't want to fail the check and have that something else tie into it. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So if you're gonna have to go there, you have to drive 3 hours to get there, and then sneak up on there. Rosa, you have survival at a decent percentage, so you could if with a successful check, you could figure out where to get eyes on them without them being able to see you. With binoculars or something like that.
All right.
Belly crawl across the desert, because that's going to be real good for your sleep and shit.
Do we know how far away the Carhenge thing he was talking about? Do we have
that's about an hour away from the site.
Okay.
On foot. It's actually closer if you drive. But
right. But it's meant to be
it's just outside the border of the site itself.
So. Okay.
It was done by an eccentric artist of Clovis. So, yeah. All right, so is that the plan, to conduct surveillance on the site immediately?
Well, getting eyes on it would be a good idea. Although if anybody starts turning into a starfish, I'm pretty sure everyone will notice.
Can we ask for a different drone?
What kind of drone?
Like a Hellfire type drone.
Well, how the fuck are you gonna? Delta Green is not like having Hellfire drones.
Yeah, I know.
Fly over the U.S. would not be
actually. Good. Well, I mean, I don't know about Hellfire drones, but getting a peek at whatever is buried at that car hinge would be a good idea, just so we know what resources we have.
Okay. Yeah, take some stock.
We also need to figure out, like, surveillance is all well and good, and we need that, but we also need to figure out how the hell we're going to close these things down. Like, Holden mentioned we could try, like, discrediting through planting fake artifacts. I still, like, I need to figure out a way to get people to not want to be on this land, like, environmental wheelhouse-wise, which I still have no idea.
Well, they're already finding erratics. That's problematic in and of itself.
They're fine. Oh, just the fact that everything's from different places?
Like they're finding items that should not be in certain strata. Like,
okay.
Yeah, things that the artifacts are very shallow depths and things like that. So.
Okay, well that's good.
Like they were dug up and then reburied at later times.
The problem is if getting the archaeologists to clear out moves too fast, and the company's going to move in. And
you could give me another ecology check. Biology.
They're both the same, but I'll go with ecology. Okay. Nope, 62.
Okay. There's in general, you know, if you dump toxic, you can dump toxic waste or bury toxic waste somewhere on the site that's shallow, you'll be able to condemn the site. But right. You don't know any way of doing that easily. So.
Okay.
So, Marshall, you could give me a law enforcement or legal criminology check.
Alrighty. 52 out of 50.
Son okay. Bitch. There's that. What do you guys want to do? So at this point, though, you realize your problem is not something that can be easily resolved, at least in a night, unless you have a clear plan of action. Right. Well, you want to go to Carhenge first, so you could do that.
Yeah, well, yeah. I mean, I got...
Right. So you drive to the Carhenge site, or get pretty close
well,
to
I figured I'd just, like, drive somewhere nearby and then, like, walk it. I got survival. Yeah. I can just go out and...
Yeah. So you're out on the desert late at night. All three of you are going, I assume.
Yeah. Going anywhere else?
All right. As you're walking, all three of you give me sand checks.
Made this one.
On 4. Damn, I'm sane as fuck tonight.
43.
So all three of you pass. All right.
I'm liking my green dice.
You're fine. You get to Carhenge. So that would be search or forensics to find anything there.
Let's see. I got search at 50.
All right.
Yeah, same here.
12.
Anyone else?
I got it at 60 and I rolled a 6.
Okay. 2 successes.
And a fail.
Okay. 2 successes is not bad. Because you find 2 things of interest. One, you find, it takes you some time, but you find evidence of something that was dug at a particular place. And then you find something else that was dug at a particular place.
Wait, separate from the cache that we were told about?
Yep.
Are they hippies?
Well, you haven't dug them up. These are the search checks. You haven't actually physically dug anything up yet, because that's going to take hours of work.
Okay.
So do you want to do that?
Yeah, I'm
here. You got your desert survival kit. You have tools. You knew you were going to be digging anyway, so you don't have to... You know, I'm not gonna be like that.
Right.
But yeah, you find 2 things. You do find a cache of weapons, and you do find a human body.
Whoa!
A skeletonized, you know, threadbare clothing. Yes. You can roll forensics, and and archaeology.
All right.
Holy shit, 40 on the nose for forensics. That is my score.
25 out of 70.
All right. I guess this was one of the hippies that the welcoming committee got a little too enthusiastic. It's a guy with a broken leg. Looks like he was beat up quite badly. Probably didn't die of his injuries. Probably looks like he, you know, or maybe he just bled out, and then they realized it was too serious, and they must have buried him here, and no one ever, and they just assume he wandered out in the desert to die. So they covered that up. But you have a human body now that you could, you know, put back in the ground. And you also have a cache of weapons. There are several Vietnam. There are three crates of Vietnam-era infantry weapons.
Holy shit!
Nice,
including grenades. Let's say, look at a flamethrower. several M16s, ammo. They were dig. Yeah. And. A few other things like that. So, EPA agent, you recognize the gas can or the fuel tank for the flamethrower has leaked over the years. It is probably that a whole thing is really explosive. So,
yeah, let's.
In fact, give me an ecology check.
Mm, 63. Don't make it.
God, you're just terrible.
Yeah. I'm the worst.
You are the worst. Why did you put 40 in your job? Like, all right, anyways.
You don't have to have, like, a super amount of expertise to be an EPA agent.
Yeah.
In fact, my character probably has more than a lot of people do.
All right.
I looked up the job requirements.
Okay. Anyways, so... Let's see here. What do you guys want to do?
Well, I'm going to grab one of these M16s.
We're going to take time to fix that. We'll bring that up to code. That is buried in the desert for a couple decades.
Oh, yeah. No, yeah. It needs to be scrubbed down like 10 times.
Well, yeah. I mean, we got to be careful moving this stuff, though, because the fuel from the flamethrowers leaked everywhere over the years. So, you know.
Seeped into the ground, probably.
Awesome.
Oh, wait a minute. Would that be our go-ahead for a shutdown?
I don't think it's going to leak that far. It's a one tank of fuel.
Give me a bureaucracy check.
I got an 8.
One. Shit out of that.
Yep.
You did?
Yeah. Well,
yeah, you know that because you know there's only one thing here. But what if you didn't know and you had to conduct an investigation?
Oh, so
it
like
it's a crime scene.
And it's better if they found some of that fuel over by the dig site, because then who knows, there could have been hoarders or weapon smugglers.
Yeah, who knows what kind of spy
was it. And it's filled with explosives, which are dangerous. Holy shit, you can't walk here, you could get blown up.
Okay.
It explains why no one wanted that, why they were hiding the site. If you just frame them to make them look like criminals.
How the fuck do we get this stuff moved?
I look at my hands and fuck.
What? Oh, look. If we can get this weapon cache on site, that would fix basically all the problems. But there are people there all the time. How are we going to fucking do that?
Everyone can give me an idea check. At technology times 5.
You can do intelligence times 5.
I failed. God damn.
Wait, are you adapted to violence?
I am, yeah.
Oh, you succeed then.
Okay.
80 out of 75, so okay. No.
Rosa, did you make it?
71 out of 75, I think.
Okay. So Duke and Rosa both realize you can plant whatever you want in there if there's an explosion. Those archaeologists got a little too eager and boom. So and then of course they're not gonna know, and if that ammo cooking off, no one's gonna notice an extra bullet hole or two. So really, and those people are already compromised. Those people probably have to go.
Oh yeah, we can wrap this whole thing up like tonight.
In a tiny tidy, bloody bow.
Yep. Just willing to shoot four innocent people. Well, are they innocent?
Questionable.
Yeah.
No.
They've been sleeping there?
They have.
Yeah, no, we have to put everyone down.
Okay. I mean, that's one way. That's the easy way of doing it.
Oh, so that means it's... Well, that's what Duke's about. So. All
right, that's the adapted to violence.
That's the idea check, or adapted to violence, auto-succeed.
It's not just the easy way, it's also the fast way, which is not necessarily a bad thing.
Well, because what if one of these fucking assholes leaves and then Starfish is out at, like, Walmart?
Yeah, but there's also the fact that if we turn this into a crime scene, that brings more people to it.
Yeah.
So we have a human body, right?
Yep.
We just leave a human body instead of the ammo cache.
Well, that's not going to solve the problem, though.
Right. No. But it would clear out the people who are sleeping overnight there.
Yeah. Let them scatter to the winds.
No.
Okay.
This would be so much easier in Soviet Russia. Just liquidate them.
That's kind of the idea, isn't it?
If it was November and Trump was president, we'd be all set.
Oh, come on. It'll take at least until December for all that stuff to get started.
Yeah, there's a honeymoon.
We could go the Fox News paranoid route.
What do you mean?
Narco traffickers attack them.
Well, you could fake that, sure.
Yeah.
But that's not going to shut the site down.
I mean, again, like the gunfire goes off. Parts of it of any of these plans means that it just shifts the timetable. It doesn't lock the land away, because then we're going to have more investigators coming in. We're going to have criminal investigators. We're going to have.
No, you realize the only way to condemn the site is either you come up with a major environmental catastrophe or somehow, or if this land is thought to have lots of fucking buried explosives, no one's going to want it because...
Oh, I see. Okay.
Also leaking environmental hazards like flamethrower fuel and shit like that. Then it's condemned and tipped for years.
That actually makes that plan sound a lot better to me.
Yeah. You just have to, you know... have the explosives found there, and how do you have the explosives found near the dig site?
By having them go off.
Yeah, by having them go off, and you kill those four people. And that way you can just kill them first, and then plant their bodies near the explosives, detonate the explosives, and then, hey, there you go.
Yeah.
Yep.
We'll just draw their own conclusion. This is, of course, the adapted violence part of your brain talking to you, for Duke at least, and, you know, the Delta Green, the unnatural part of you, the other. So
I'm just going to say...
I ain't adapted to shit, so...
I'm listening if there's any alternatives, but,
I mean...
What's the alternative?
Yeah, this is the crux of the scenario. What are you going to do? What are you willing to transgress in order to, you know, Atherton, maybe this is all crazy. That's crazy. You could just lie to Holden, tell him it's no big deal. Maybe you just blew things out of proportion.
Yeah, I saw a starfish thing.
There's no coming back from the starfish.
Yep. You could have left that thing in the green box. It would have. Yeah.
Can I get a sand back? Because I know it's dead.
All right, I'll give you a sand back.
Yay!
You
want
to die. Oh, hey, yeah.
So,
Technically, shouldn't the coroner get it back?
Oh, that's another loose end. We need to tie up.
He's a friend. He's
Delta Green. Holden, like, contacted him for us. He knows shit.
Yeah. The only loose end is Silva. He talked. He needs to go.
I haven't told anybody about that.
Yeah, that's true. This is the crisis scenario. Like, what are you willing to do to get the job done? And there's no moral way to do it, you know, that you can think of. I mean, there might be a way to thread the needle, but you haven't found it.
Yeah, no.
If you could probably find that way, if you gave it time, you could always go back and do more research. You could always go back and do more.
You don't have time.
Well, see, there you go. That's a choice. You're making a choice right there. You're the one deciding there's not time.
Yeah. See, the only way we could buy time is by massacring them, turning it into a crime scene, and then waiting for them.
No, that's not buying time. That is the... Stop trying to murder a bunch of people to buy time. If we're murdering people, it's the end of the thing.
Yeah, you could have the site condemned if they blew up as a result
of survivalists burying ashes. Yeah. Vietnam weaponry, like that's the play.
Mm-hmm.
How about this, Atherton? I'll stay here if the doctor wants to stay here. That's cool. You have like 12 hours to try to figure something out, and if not,
do you? It's about midnight right now. It's about 10 o'clock right now. So
I'll stay on site, and if things get fucky, like I'll try to handle it.
Okay. You have to get closer. I mean, you're way outside of the... You're, like, not line of sight of... you're not within sight range of the dig site right now. You don't know what's going on there.
We're trying to call in more people. We don't know how many more are going to get dragged into this if we take more time.
Okay, that is true. So what is your decision?
Let's call Holden.
Okay.
Kick it up to the team.
Well, I don't.
You tell me Holden everything.
I'm not. I haven't told anybody about the old guy that I haven't mentioned. But
all right. So aside from you're saving Silva, save that old man. He deserves it. All right. So you tell Holden everything else. He says
the play that we have.
Yeah. The first thing he suggests is to go to the site, execute them all. Put their bodies.
Do I need to roll sand on that one?
Yeah, go ahead.
Because I am not adapted to violence.
Yeah.
I'm walking towards the car.
There we go.
I made mine.
82.
That's a failure?
That is a failure.
One. And that's one check mark for adaptive to violence. Yeah, you're in a group that's talking about murdering American citizens for being in the wrong place at the wrong time. They haven't committed a crime. They haven't done anything wrong. They might become bad. They might turn. You don't know that's the thing. That hiker who turned into the starfish did so overnight the first night he slept there. They've been there almost a week now, and they show no signs of changing, as far as you know.
Maybe it has to be the right type of person. Maybe they aren't outcasts.
Exactly.
Nothing.
So yeah, exactly. So you don't know why they were spared and while others haven't.
There's a chance that if they burn Forsyth's credentials and she becomes outcast while she's still sleeping there, might not be good.
You don't know what the significance of the outcast part. So he says that will condemn the site. The group is actually well prepared to. Fake evidence to fake intelligence or tips that this was a place used by weapon smugglers. That we can later have other groups insert more material, other weapons, caches.
That was my question because we don't have enough to really make a minefield, an actual minefield.
It's only the suggestion of a minefield, the fear of it, and we only have to have a few discoveries. The fear of it will keep people off that land for decades. We could plant some. We have access. I know I have access to depleted uranium weapons. So,
good. Okay, that's good.
Yeah, he missed another sand check there, Atherton, because that's one of your bonds is make a sustainable world ecology. If you're talking about putting uranium in the ground,
that one I make. No, it's fine. Okay, whatever.
Well, it is New Mexico. It's putting uranium back in the ground.
Here's my thought on that is really like if
if whatever's down there is some sort of oceanic ancient mucky muck, you know, what it, you, everyone knows where oil comes from, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, so I'm presuming, like, my, you know, crazy conspiratorial, like, the oil there is from some dead monster god, and I don't really think, yeah, we need people not to be there.
Rosa, as soon as you say that, Rosa just says, just automatically, that which is not that which is not dead may eternal lie, and even in stranger.
Did she say this while we're on the call?
Yes, she just kind of automatically says that. She kind of looks startled at herself. Rosa, give me a check.
Yep. Yep, I deserve that. All right.
I deserve that.
Well, I chose that background. I failed.
Let's see here. Okay. Cthulhu. All right. So. All right. Yeah. You. You failed that sand check. All right. That is a D4.
That is
give me another sand check.
I have now.
I don't know what you guys are talking about. 15. All right.
Can you make it?
Yep.
Okay, so you don't have an amnesia episode, but yeah, you do remember more of your job. You remember they're talking about it. They're talking about these things. You know, it's another argument, or it's a briefing, talking about how there is a town that was contaminated. The people there were wrong. They weren't physiologically human entirely. The government went in there, killed them, or contained them all. But now you're going back. Now the town is a ghost town. It's been abandoned. There's, you know, well, it sometimes those things they die, but they come back. These things they may live in the ocean now, but that doesn't mean they need the ocean to live. You know, they're beyond us. If they're sleeping, if they're dead, who knows what under what conditions they could become a threat again. So you realize whatever's in if there is something in the ground there, it doesn't necessarily need the ocean's waters. You don't know what would bring it back. Maybe it's not the environment. Maybe it's something else.
So I basically sum that up. Yeah. Oh, I think that's a good guess. That's a good guess, Atherton. Good guess.
Cool. You all right?
Yeah. The fuck
is that? Back to an old job.
Okay.
That is not dead, which can eternal lie, and even with strange eons, even death may die. Sorry, that is the couplet in its entirety. Sorry.
Okay.
So yeah.
I didn't know.
So is the decision? We'll just put it to a vote. Unless the choices are just to prevent. You know, you could discuss this all night, and your characters probably will want to.
Right.
One is, you know, do the bad thing, kill the people. Fake condemnation of the land with the explosives. Two, leave and research what's going on and try and figure out of a morally acceptable solution. Three, I guess lie to Holden and figure out some way to get out of this without having to resolve it yourself. I mean, those are the only three options I see. Are there any other options? I can't think of any.
I don't have anything.
All right. So, Duke, what is your vote?
I pull out the 44 and pull the hammer back.
All right. Let's go. Yeah.
All right. You do realize you shouldn't pull the hammer back like while we're not there. Yeah.
It was for dramatic effect. And I cock it back.
Rosa, what is your
there but for the grace of God.
Okay.
Go I.
Two out of three.
I could have been them.
Yeah.
But
I saw the old guy, and you know, the body on the ground is the cost of keeping everybody else safe. I told the old guy it was my responsibility, so I'm not saying that part out loud. This is just my thought process. So
I'm just gonna look at both of them and be like, look, they're not people anymore. Get that shit out of your heads. They're not fucking people.
Okay. So everyone, let's see, one person leading the way across the desert at night. I guess that would probably be Rosa.
Okay.
So go ahead and give me a survival check. make sure you can get there without turning your flashlights on.
Rolled a 14, so I easily made it.
All right. So you navigate to the site. It's a cloudy night. There's not much moonlight. It's after midnight, and you're dragging a heavy cache of, you know, a footlocker full of explosives and nasty things, or two of you are, while one of you's up ahead. So you're within sight of the camp. You see some flashlights flickering about. It looks like they are, you know, there's looks like there's four people there total. You know there's four people there, but you don't know where they are. So all three of you can give me alertness checks.
Good, I have some.
God damn it, 52 out of 50.
Okay.
75 out of 70.
Okay.
And 83.
I didn't even give you penalties, by the way, because it's fine, because you got time. All right, so you only see where one of them is. There are three people. You don't know where they are at this distance. So what is your game plan?
Well, I got the sweet flare gun.
sweet flare gun. That's going to be seen from Clovis.
Yeah, it's going to be... We got to...
Yeah.
The flare gun is put it away. Don't, no.
That would be a good way of igniting the explosives from a distance.
Yeah, but for the moment, we need to get it, like, we need them not to scatter. We have to go in and...
Well, don't you have a machine gun in that crate?
Several, but they're not functional.
We don't know the operating condition of any of them, so as far as we know, just the pieces we have on us are the ones we know will work.
Yeah. This is true. You could try to fire them, though, without... That's going to be an interesting luck check.
We need to get in there, and we need to get them close together. I say we go in.
Yeah, I think that's all we got. Maybe... Do you guys want to spread out or stay together?
Wait. I can do it. They know me. They know me as an academic.
Yeah, that's literally what I'm saying, is we go in, we bring them together, like...
Oh.
We have an academic, we have law enforcement, and we have EPA. Like, we, all of us can have decent reasons to be there and to gather them up, is what I'm saying.
Okay. But not at the same time. That would be weird.
No, I mean, we all go in and say that there's news, like there's something important has happened on the site. I'm in, like... Well, something has happened about, like, information about the site. We get people together, and we just do it.
I mean, it would look better if we drove up instead of walked out of the desert, but, yeah, I mean...
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So the three of you are just walking up?
No, I say, why not go and get the vehicle and just drive up?
Okay. What are you doing with the weapons? You're just going to put them by a bush, essentially? Hide them nearby.
Yeah, anybody else have any better plans?
I want to observe them. Could you guys go get the car? I'll sit next to the box of guns, and then when you drive up, I'll get in. And...
Okay.
So is that a good idea?
Probably not.
Okay.
I mean, with your little episode...
It would help me if I see them doing something crazy before I kill them.
Okay.
All right, okay. Let's go. All
righty.
Let's see here, Rosa. This is interesting. All right, so you go out, you're by yourself on the site, and you're real tired because you've been pushing yourself real hard. So give me a sand check.
God damn it. Roll the 4. All right.
Okay. You're still kind of nodding, but you're up. When you think you hear something in the distance, like a song or something. You can't. It's off to the side and to the right. If you could get closer, you could probably hear it better. Hear what it was. Do you follow or do you stay where you are?
I squat down. So the light from my phone won't shine. I text my husband. I love him very much.
Oh, okay. And what do you do?
I do not follow the song yet.
Oh, okay.
But if I'm hearing it, I'm nervous.
Oh, yeah. You can give me an unnatural roll.
Oh, God.
Her husband gets it next. Cthulhu Futagen, really.
Oh, by the way, double your unnatural skill.
Mm-hmm. Oh, God.
God damn it, I rolled a 19. So I made it.
Yes. You hear the song. It's like whale song, but it's more beautiful. And
song, but sexier.
Yeah. It's and you feel the waters rising over you, but that's okay for a moment. You can give me a sand check.
Oh God. Okay.
Man, Ross is just making it rain sand checks.
Yeah. Rolled a 20, so I'm still.
Okay, you shake in, you know, you're back in the desert. You're not wet. The ocean was not rising. You did not see it, but you're right over it, and it needs your help. It wants to be rebuilt, and it needs you're at. Yeah, you're trying to keep the presence out of your head. Meanwhile, the two of you, are you running, or are you just going to, you know, meander back?
Yeah, no, we're in a hurry.
Okay. Yeah. Dex times 5. Running across the desert at night.
Gosh, fucking
99.
Oh, God.
That's a crit failure. All right, let's see how much damage that is. Let's see here. That is 3 points of damage. Ow, ow, ow. That ankle was not supposed to twist that way.
God damn it.
Well, you ran across the desert at night without a flashlight, so. And I forgot, were you taking the weapon footlocker with you or not?
No, we left that bag with
us. Okay. Yeah, okay. Sitting next to it.
All right. So yeah, you're not running. You're not running anymore, Duke. You can limp.
All right.
Actually, do you? There's messages in the chat. Oh, cool. That's just you guys. So the two of you. Do either of you have first aid?
Nope.
Nope.
All right.
I have survival. Can that be useful?
Yep, his leg's definitely twisted. He should not walk on it anymore. He should keep pressure off of it. I'll give you that for free. You can either help him or abandon him and get to the vehicle faster.
I'm gonna...
get the vehicle. Just pick me up.
Are we in a place where I could just drive back and grab him?
Yeah. With a drive check.
Okay, yeah. Then I'm gonna do that. You wait here, I'm gonna get the car.
Awesome, right, I'm sure nothing check. Bad will happen.
Because I made a 23 on my dex times whatever, so I'm alright.
Yeah, give me a drive check, Atherton.
29 out of 50, motherfucker.
Okay, alright. drive at night. Comes back and picks up his agent. So the two of you start heading towards the site with your headlights on, I assume, because you're official, man.
Well, I mean, we're gonna have him out until we pick up
Rosa,
and then, yeah.
Okay. All right, so Rosa, last sand check.
This can't last. 42, made it.
Okay, it's like the pressure is building on you. You know, like before a thunderstorm, you can just feel feel the difference in air pressure, and it's just building and building and building. You just have to close your eyes and put your hands to your ears and just kind of. Focus on not giving in to it. But
so
you
I
do.
Can't make any observations of the camp while I'm basically just fighting.
Yeah, right now you cannot do anything like that. You are by yourself. And that is not good for you in particular. So you're just trying not to understand it. You're just trying to block it out. So you don't take any sand damage, but you... Well, actually, if you could try and do something useful while doing that if you want to. That's a choice.
That is a choice.
Okay, No, I need to stay not crazy pants. Not crazy.
Okay, yeah. That's what you're doing. So the two of you get back, and you can see Rosa is just clutched over, hands on her head, eyes closed.
All right.
Kind of rocking back and forth.
I guess I'm gonna try and help her up.
Okay. So you help her up. She kind of startled by your presence. But yeah, as soon as he touches you, you're just like back in normal reality. You don't feel anything anymore.
Here?
It's fucking with me.
Oh, that's good.
No, it's not.
Well, Duke twisted his ankle while we were trying to get back to the vehicle, so we're a great crew right now.
We run a tight ship.
Thanks. Let's get this done.
Yeah. All right, the three of you roll in with the footlocker in the vehicle, I assume?
Yeah.
And the Desert Survival Pack.
Yeah, and the Desert Survival Pack. All right. With that, the four people who are there who just sort of are very curious. There's one person comes out of a tent. Paisley was sleeping, apparently. The other three grad students were kind of milling about.
By the way, before we get out of the vehicle, here's the plan. I'm going to EPA, I'm going to flash the EPA credentials and basically get all four to sit down with us to talk. And Duke, I'm assuming you are a better shot than me, so I want you to be behind wherever I get them to sit down, and then we just start it that way.
Got it.
And Rosa, you—I don't know. You do whatever you need to do. I don't.
I just take
sides, and we'll basically have them boxed in: me in front, him behind, and them on the side. So shoot down, I guess.
Okay.
Well, you're on the same ground level. I mean, you can't really shoot down.
Well, yeah. No. Well, I mean, that's why I said I wanted to like. Anyway, So let's.
All right. So. You get there, Dr. Paisley is Fowler, the front says, hello, can I help you?
Yeah. I flash my badge. I'm with the EPA. I've been investigating some of the background and on this site and what's been going on here. And I need to talk to everybody on site and ask a few interview questions just to
persuade.
Yeah. Do. Come on. Oh! Ot one.
Okay. So she's like, oh. We don't want to have any problem with the EPA. This is a very important cultural site, archaeological site. Are we in danger? I mean, this is highly unusual. Couldn't have waited until morning.
Well, I just got into town and I don't want to waste time, but a lot of it has to do with the kind of mining they're wanting to do and possible presence of heavy metals in some of the dig sites. And I just want to make sure to talk to everybody who's here and double check, make sure nobody's having any odd reactions.
Okay. All right. So you're talking that. So Rosa and Duke, you're in position. Who wants to do a thing first?
I'm waiting for the violent person to go first.
All right, Duke, yeah.
The specialist in violence.
Well, I'm going to kind of wait for a signal. I'm going to peek up at Atherton when I get it.
As soon as everybody's there, I just, glance at him or whatever.
Okay.
All right. I'm just going to pull out the 44, and that's I roll a 4.
Okay. Are you shooting Paisley or one of the grad students first?
Paisley's going down first.
All right, she just falls over. It's probably a D12 or a D10. She goes down. She's not dead, but she's in shock. The other two agents both give me those sand checks.
43 out of 63. Not great.
That's one sand, and you've
36. So one.
All right, yeah, and you lost sand from a.
Oh yeah, so 81 on the subsequent roll.
Yeah, so you failed that.
Oh yeah.
You don't know where you are. You don't know what's going on. You have bear spray in your hand, so there are people screaming and panicking. So I don't know what bear spray is rated. I think it's just like 50% or something.
I think it's dex times 5.
Okay, yeah, go. Give me dex times 5.
I think I'll just hit the two people nearest me. 32 out of 55.
Yeah, two of the students just get sprayed in the face, and they're screaming. Dude, just give me 3 more firearms check. You can end this.
All right. I make ought 7 on mine.
Oh, you're shooting too. All right. Watching is one thing. Doing it is another sand check. There.
I figured.
That's a 65 on the first roll. Okay.
96. I fail that sand check.
Okay. Well, that's killing a... let's see here. You're probably adapted to violence. That's only 2.
No, it's only 2.
Yeah, but that's probably your second or third check mark for adapted to violence, so you're probably adapted to violence now.
What do I lose on the...
Well, don't worry about it right now. It's fine. All right.
Good.
You shot one and you shot one too. So two more grad students go down. They're not combatants. You know, one bullet's enough. So one more of you, just give me one more shot.
I got a 66, which is a crit.
All right, yeah, all of them are on the ground.
I walk up to Paisley and empty the rest of the gun into her head.
Okay.
I run screaming off because I don't know what the fuck's going on.
You chose flight. Yeah, you're running into the desert.
Get her. I can't fucking run.
No, I'm fucking running after
her. Okay. So, Duke, give me a criminology give me a forensics check to fake this crime scene.
Holy fuck, I made it 28 out of 30.
Good job. What with your... all right, so you start dragging the bodies, concealing the evidence.
They would look best this way.
Yeah, and basically you have to pile them around, basically get them to the dig site, and put the basically look like they opened up the cache and they all blew up at the same time. Like, put them point blank in front of the footlocker, and then you just have to ignite the footlocker somehow. There are grenades and fucking flamethrower fuel in it. It's going to go up like 4th of July. And then you just have to be nowhere around it. By the way, you're in your rented vehicle, by the way.
I know. But it might have to get
stolen. Which is very traceable.
It might have to get stolen on the way home.
Yeah, maybe, you think? with it smelling like flamethrower fuel now?
we're just going to scuttle that.
That'll expedite.
All right, process. Atherton and Rosa, both of you give me dex times 5 checks.
43 out of 55.
71 out of 50, so no.
All right, she's gaining ground. You're losing her in the dark. You can do one more thing. You can either one more chance to catch up with her, yell out to her, try to persuade her to stop, shoot her. I don't know. What do you want to do?
I'm just going to try and... I'm just going to yell out to... Oh, shit. I don't want to be yelling her name.
Yeah.
Because who knows who might hear.
Yeah.
I can't shoot her. God damn it. Oh, fuck. I don't know what to do.
All right, that's your action. You stop running. You're just kind of like, running's probably the pretty much automatic reaction.
Yeah.
Keep running. So both of you give me dex times 5 checks again.
Okay.
Ought 2. Wow.
Okay. 19 out of 55.
All right. Still, she got a higher margin of success than you. So, Rosa, you're running.
Wait. Can I send her a text?
You don't have signal. You do have signal out here. So, yeah, you could send her a text.
Stop running.
Can I get somebody to do that? It's like Rosa.
Your phone is buzzing.
As soon as I feel safe, I'll take a look at my phone.
Right, someone's chasing after you.
Yeah.
Do you have stealth?
I base.
Okay. You also have bear spray. You could bear spray him.
If he catches me, I'll bear spray him, but
okay,
yeah.
Okay, so you're just running into the desert.
Yeah.
Okay.
There's no good reason. You wake up and there's shooting all over.
Give me another sand check. You might remember eventually. You don't know how long this will... It'll see how long until you, like, either...
Like, I'm gonna...
Well, you do know you're a Delta Green agent in this kind
of... That's why I'm not calling 911 right away.
Yeah, all right, that's fair.
I gotta stop and go back and help him set up the scene. Like,
so you stop and let her run into the night.
Yeah, fuck it.
Okay.
43. So okay. I made it.
All right, so you get a ways out there, and so you're not, but you stop and
you know you're a ways out there, message. Nice and alone.
Yeah.
Again.
For one more sand check, because you're still alone on this night.
Son of a bitch, all right. Oh, God. Merry fucking Christmas. 72. Failed it.
All right. You're in the ocean, but you're fine. So we'll get back to you in a second. After you run back to the site, Duke yells at you to, you know, get that brush and cover up those drag marks.
Right.
So he knows what to do. So both of you give me strength times 5 checks.
42. Made it.
Okay.
Fail. 86. Then 50.
Your leg.
You can either, you take, 1 point of damage, and cut yourself and give me a sand check. Oh, God.
I failed that one.
All right. 2 sand. Oh, God. You're leaving evidence behind on a quadruple murder. Like, oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. You're not enough to panic. But you have rage disorder. Give me a check on that.
Yeah. God. I pass. 16.
All right. So you keep your shit together.
Can I pull out my flask of Everclear and pour it on my blood?
Yeah.
All right, done.
Yeah, you're fine. So...
And then I take out one pull off of it and hand it to Atherton.
So that's really good before some night driving out in the desert.
Not while I'm working, thanks.
Yeah.
I take his.
The one thing is the bodies are piled up as good as you can see. Your main problems are, one, igniting the explosives, and two, getting away.
Yeah.
And... problem of getting away. What to do with Rosa?
Duke, how drunk are you right now?
She's running back towards town.
Oh, that is the first sip I've had. It's,
okay,
then I want 3 people.
You can't run off into the desert in the middle of the night. So I want you to take the car and everything else. I'll set off the explosion. I know a little bit about getting through a desert. I can meet back up with you out somewhere.
All right. I'll go find a shitty motel and give me a call.
All right, you need to try and establish contact with Rosa. She freaked the fuck out and ran.
All right.
That's what I got.
All right. Let's see here. Give me a driving check.
All right. 42 out of 50.
Okay. You get away.
I'm going to call Rosa.
Huh?
I'm going to keep calling Rosa as I'm driving out.
All right. Your signal is coming and going, so, and Rosa's not available at the moment, so.
the service area.
So, Atherton.
Yeah.
How long are you going to give him before you detonate the explosives?
I'm going to give him
because gunfire is also noticeable, so you really want them as close as together, because that could be, like, the cooked off ammo or whatever.
Yeah.
Already been maybe too long.
Right.
But, you know, you just blow it as soon as he's safe?
Yes. As soon as he's out of sight, I'm going to wait, like, a couple of minutes and just, like, pull a grenade pin and book it.
Okay. Let's see here. All right. Do you want high or low?
Let's go with high.
Okay. High? Okay. What was that for? You don't know. Actually, well, we'll get that. Just remind me at the end of the game, and I'll tell you what that was for.
All right.
And Rosa.
Yes.
You're in the ocean. You think you're in the ocean. Your senses are just basically you're getting conflicting senses.
I mean, you're it feels pretty oceany.
Yeah. You're in the desert, but you're also in the ocean, and you realize this is not the ocean. It's the dream of an ocean. Someone else's dream. You're in someone else's dream. You're beginning to have a realization of what's happening to you. There is someone below you that is dead, but is not dead. And it wants to go. It is isolated. It was cut off from its others of its kind. And it just wants to go to be with them, to just wake up enough long enough to travel back to its kind.
That's so wrong.
And it needs the help of people to rebuild itself, because it can teach you how to rebuild itself, how to rebuild living things, how to make living things like another living thing. And it wants to teach you, because you can use it to help rebuild it. It's getting every. There have been many people over the years who have helped it rebuild itself, and it's getting closer now. And you realize this. If it's gone, it can't hurt the site anymore. The site will just be another place. It's almost ready. So, how do you react to this? Is this horror, or is this fascination with an alien being? I mean, what do you want to help it? Do you just like, no, from hell's heart I stab at thee, kind of thing? How does Rosa react?
I think it would be horror, because the last time she was vaguely anything related to this, she blocked out instinctively. Yeah.
And mercifully, that's what happens again. You're overwhelmed. You cannot accept its offer. And you pass out. So, Atherton, real important for you to make an alertness check.
Alrighty. Alertness is 50, and my roll is 53.
Woo! All right. You don't know where she is. What do you do?
Don't know where who is.
Rosa.
We ran a while before she got back.
I know, right? So you can't find her. You don't know where she is.
I know. That's what I'm saying. It's like, okay. I'm pulling the thing and I'm booking it. Like, that's...
Okay. All right. So you're running for a while. Give me a survival check.
All righty. Shit, 61 out of 40. Nope.
Okay. Shit. You're in the path of the response vehicles. Let's see here.
Wait, I wouldn't be running on the road.
Well, no, it's not a road, but like, well, you got sort of turned around, and the most direct path is through this particular path. So, let's see here. Do you have athletics? You could dive into a ditch and hide from the vehicles.
Yeah, I suppose that'll have to be it. Yep. 28 out of 50.
Okay, you dive into a ditch as they drive by you, and you narrowly avoid being detected. Mm. So do you just avoid... Are you going to try and find Rosa before bugging out, or are you just going
to
bug out?
No, I told Duke to try and establish contact with Rosa. I can't, like, I...
Okay. All right, Rosa, give me sand check.
I rolled a 99, because I was waiting for that.
Critical failure. Yep. You wake up in an ambulance. So you hear your phone ringing, but there's EMTs checking you. So yeah, they found you. What are you going to do? Did you have ID on you? I guess you must. Did you have ID on you, or did you go with the Niable?
I was going under BIA auspices.
Okay. So you have your ID on you. You don't know if they've checked or not, but you're in the back of the ambulance, driving back to civilization. Are you going to try to escape?
No. Okay. No. I am not an action hero.
I'm okay. A marshal.
All right, so you're caught. Yep. Let's see here. One last survival check for prosecution. All right. Atherton, sorry.
Nope. Wow. Way to get a survival score at all, dipshit.
Okay. Not
critical, but just not great.
Okay. Well, you can choose whether you can, you know, get caught or wander in the desert for 1d3 days.
I'm going to wander in the desert for 1d3 days.
Okay, let's see if you die.
All right. That'll be fun.
All right, it's 3 days in the desert. Give me another survival check.
Okay. 65 out of 40, nope.
Okay.
So thirsty.
Let's see, how many hit points do you have?
I have 12.
12? All right, you take, you did have some supplies on you. You did say you did take the, well, there was a survival kit. You probably took that with you.
Right.
But 5, 8. You take 8 hit points damage. Are you still alive?
Yeah.
All right. It's a bad fucking 3 days, and you're overdue for work. No one's heard of you for 3 days.
What? So, like, yeah. Has there been, like, no, even the contact stuff that Holden gave me?
No, you got lost in the desert. Like, your cell phone died. You're just away from civilization. You show up like 50 miles away from the site at a nearby town before you rediscover civilization. It's a fucking desert. Like, yeah.
Yeah. No, I was just being sure.
All right. So you might get fired. Because where the fuck were you? And you were seen near this area asking questions and shit like that, and it's turned into a huge clusterfuck. So yeah, let's deal with fallout. First off, Duke, give me another forensics check to, you know, what are you gonna do with the car?
I was gonna see if I could roll criminology to make it disappear.
Alright. Criminology, yeah, you could have it, yeah, disappear.
50 out of 50.
Nice. Okay.
Nice.
In that case, give me a luck check. You can choose whether it's high or low.
You
just have a 50% chance. Just roll a percentile. Well, say ahead of time if you want high or low.
Okay, I'll go low.
Okay.
10.
Woo!
Your insurance buys it. You know, you're comped for it. The car is never found.
I get comped for it.
Well, yes. It's not here yet. Insurance. That's why when people's cars get stolen, they get it back. You know. It's,
oh, God bless America.
Well, it's bad. Well, it's a rental car, so you just don't have to pay the rental.
Oh, yeah.
So, so you don't lose anything. So you don't have to worry about your bonds. So Atherton, you're gone for you're MIA for 3 days near disaster. So you're under review. Let's see here. Give me a law check.
All right. 89 out of 30, so no.
Okay. Actually, did you want... Oh, I before you did that. Let's see here. Do you want to get fired? Where is it? Blah, 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 blah. Actually, give me a persuade check. Or a bureaucracy check to see if you're going to take disciplinary action.
Well, bureaucracy is better than persuade for me.
All right.
Wow, my dice have betrayed me in the late game. 90 out of 60.
Sand check, you've been fired.
Nope. Oh, now you give me another ought to, you bastards.
Give me a charisma check. You know, charisma times 5. Or lose 1d4 points from each bond.
I critically fail.
Well, for each bond. So you're basically you get fired. You are fired from the EPA. You know, because you're not being forthcoming with your answers.
Right.
They don't have anything they can prove on you, and they don't want to, you know, suffer blame themselves. But you know. So yeah, Dr. Rosa, give me a,
Do I even remember anything?
Yeah, give me a persuade check. Do you have persuade?
Base. Okay. Oh, wait, no. It's a 40.
All right, give me a persuade check.
Okay. Come on, don't screw me like you screwed me 1 minute ago. Oh my god, I told you not to screw me. 55.
Critical failure.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, you are charged with well, looks like they think that you were the ones digging up the weapons, and that you are to blame. You're negligent homicide for getting these people blown up. That you did not fail to tell people that they're. So you can give me a luck roll. Well, if you want to, you can make a law check to work the system.
Okay.
Your luck.
I have 0% in law, so no.
Okay. Let's see here. Yeah, so just give me a luck check.
You want to roll it, or?
Okay, I'll roll it.
Okay, high, please. High or low?
You want a high? 51 and above. 94! You are not charged. You're not prosecuted. They don't have a case.
I was going to say, there's no cordite on my hands.
Yeah. Well, they want to blame somebody. There's four dead people, and now there's a huge fucking wreck. And a month later, they find depleted uranium. So, well, they think you're withholding things. You were found at the scene. You're not being very forthcoming. So your career with the Bureau is done, obviously. You're still fired, so make a sand check for that.
Oh, God. Gonna forget this, too. 27. Made that.
All right. It's helplessness, but yeah, you're fine. It was a 0-1, so... yeah, you're fired, so you'll have to find some other way to make your ends living. You might not... The group may no longer have a use for you. So that ends it, but you stopped a major threat. The sleeper will remain sleeping. No one saw the vehicle drive off. That's what the luck check was for.
I was wondering.
Because there was a massive explosion which lit up everything nearby, and it's a fucking SUV driving through the desert. Someone might have heard it. Mm-hmm. And no one noticed the tracks. There were vehicle tracks all over the place because it was a dig site. You managed to cover it up. You managed to do the right thing.
In as murdery a way as possible.
Yeah. That was the thing. It's not a problem that's easy to make go away. I mean, what do you do when the land itself is corrupted? Right. So
we need to put that stone obelisk with the translatable in every way thing.
So questions, comments, suggestions. You guys have any questions about it? Have fun.
No, that was awesome. When I cut my hand in the beginning, did that like wake it up?
It was already in hibernated. I mean, like a little blood didn't make it. If there was a biological character, you would have noticed one area is a little more pink than the others. But you would have had to like give it up, a shower in order to really wake it up.
You
could have talked to it. You got all kinds of useful information. A ritual you could have done to keep it asleep.
A ritual. Yeah.
I do not think we were prepared for that conversation, so I made a call.
No, not at all.
Yeah.
There were people listening.
Who's our occult expert? Actually, yeah, Rosa, you go talk to it. That'll be good.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah. My dice karma.
So the basic idea is that there was a, it wasn't Cthulhu, it was not Cthulhu, obviously, but it was a star spawn of Cthulhu that was, it was just there. It just got cut off and, it was just sleeping there.
Just hanging out.
And they all died and they turned oil.
And anyone who slept in that area had its dreams, and it was using the psychic energy of those people to basically rebuild itself. So it could, like, the worst, if you had actually helped it, or if the dig site had gone on long enough, it just would have been able to fully rebuild itself, and then it just would have walked to the Pacific Ocean, which would have been, from
that would be bad.
That would have been very bad. A lot of people would have died. But you stop that from happening, at least.
Go team!
Yay!
Until the Superfund cleanup is done, in which case, those oil sands are really useful. So you kick the can down the road quite a way. So, any other questions or comments?
So Duke just goes back to work on Monday?
Basically, yeah.
Nice.
He never met those people before. He doesn't want to know what happens to them afterwards. He gets a gold star from Delta Green. He did his job well.
Once Rosa didn't know what the fuck was going on, she just needed to get the fuck out of there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was kind of leaning on the insanity a little more, but like it presented, I think, a good story option.
Yeah.
There's no neat little occult MacGuffin to solve it.
I rub anti-magic on the magic, and that.
Yeah. Well, you didn't want. No, you didn't, because you didn't talk to the starfish. The starfish could have given you.
I don't talk to starfish, Ross. Yeah, I get it. I'm racist. Thank you.
Starfish lives matter.
It's not my fault we grew up in the Midwest, okay? We have very old-fashioned notions about starfish.
Yeah, human starfish. Thanks to the Delta Green email list who gave me some of the ideas for the scenario, including the human starfish thing.
That's so gross. I love it.
Yeah.
It reminds me of like an SCP thing.
Yeah. Some people are more affected by the star spawn than others. So, hope you guys liked it. But that would be the end of this little scenario.
Awesome. Yeah. Thank you.